Eric the Midget has live commentary, and he's got a female sidekick.
Wow.
But I don't know. I take it they're on some sort of weird connection, because the whole thing, she echoes every time she talks.
So they've got the technology down.
Yeah, she's like, Eric. You know,
and it goes on through the whole show. Nobody ever corrects it.
Yeah, and it's like the show. I haven't heard all these tapes, but the show is in two phases. It's one is like where listeners will ask questions and stuff.
While American Idol is going
on. This is all during American Idol. Like, Eric's on the camera. I don't know if the chick's on the camera, but he is definitely on the camera.
And he's watching American Idol.
You watch him watch American Idol, and he makes commentary. And he's got the chick sidekick, who I think is in another location, I'm assuming.
Right.
By this echoing. I have clips. I had J.D. pull some clips. I mean, I could listen to it all day. If you tell me if it gets boring, all right? Because I'm fascinated.
You have no judgment
right.
on this.
All right, here's Eric. You can hear the singing going on in the background. He's watching American Idol, and he's offering his play-by-play. And the girl is, too. I don't know the girl's name.
Oh, my God. Do you hear this guy, Eric?
Unfortunately, yes. Some of these contestants make you wish you were deaf.
Some of these contestants, they make you want to slit your wrists. They're really bad. Here's my question. Don't they have anybody around them that likes them and loves them and would be honest enough with them just to say, dude, you can't sing?
Guess not.
Wow, this
and
is
Internet Warrior said because her relatives are Riri's too.
Eric doesn't say
needs
much.
To give up, don't you think?
He should have gave up before he went in.
Yeah.
I think the guy could keep trying, but he's never going to achieve getting better.
No.
Well, there's
wow.
Ridiculous. There's a little segment from the Eric the Midget show.
Listen, I'm going to answer that chick by saying, listen, we're Eric's loved ones, and we have to be honest. He sucks at radio. And so do you.
Yeah.
That's amazing.
Well, that's what goes on during the show, but also there are moments where Eric
takes
questions and discusses stuff with his sidekick.
Eric, do you have any... He says, any other reality... Oh, do you like any other reality shows? And that is from Rushmore.
Well, The Girls Next Door. let's see, who else? Keeping Up with the Kardashians. That's a pretty good one. Little People, Big World.
Oh, my goodness.
America's Got Talent. And there's quite a few that I watch.
Nice. Nice. And guys, the reason he sounds so different is because this is the real Eric. So this is what he really sounds like live and raw.
Yeah, no more,
none of that, and what they make fun of him on Stern. This is the real Eric. That's why he sounds different.
Yeah, it's called being on air. It's called getting a little nervous.
Yeah. Well, that's true. No, people were wondering why you sounded different here than on Stern. Yes.
Yeah.
He does sound different.
Wow. What? What?
Is this a bit? You think that's really Eric?
Yeah, that's Eric.
It doesn't sound like
really?
Him at all.
It's nothing like his voice. It's like some guy on helium.
No, that's Eric. In fact, the reason it sounds different is because he's not on the phone. We're not used to hearing him in person.
I mean,
no, it's Eric. You can see it's Eric.
Yeah, I never.
The answers were right at the shows he liked and stuff, but
because it's Eric.
Yeah, no,
he's just not used to hearing him.
He's saying he's nervous. That's why.
No, I'm not just saying the pauses. I'm saying the whole voice is different.
His voice is different.
That's Eric.
I don't know. For some reason, I never thought it was a fake. No, I don't know.
I don't think it's a fake, but he does. He sounds like he's being strangled.
It just sounds different because you're hearing him.
Yeah, he's always on the phone here, right? I mean, this is like the.
You want to hear more Eric the Midget?
Well, I like the question and answer thing.
You want more of that?
Yeah.
I got to say, this is entertaining.
All right. All right, here's Eric the Midget answering more questions.
Okay.
Somebody wants to know if you are following the writer's strike, or are you going to keep writing your script? That came from Sid Jr.
Well, really, right now, Stern is not really earning the script with his behavior lately.
Oh. This guy won't give up, Eric. Listen to him. This guy won't give up. Look, here comes security. I love it. I love it. I love the lunacy. This is great.
It's like, damn, there's less than an hour left of the show. Come on, get this guy out of there.
Yeah, Eric, the room wants to know, too, if you're going to call into the show tomorrow.
I don't know. I have to think about that one.
Okay. Well, tomorrow's Thursday, and you know that, you know, the dare was by Thursday, so...
Right. But Johnny keeps saying that I should not even try to antagonize or anything like that. I'm like, damn, I want to rub it in that idiot's face that he's going to fail.
He's going to fail. So, well, we'll see. We'll call Johnny after the show, and we'll see what's up.
Right.
Wow.
You haven't earned the script.
Wait a minute. Fail at what? Who's going
to... We were supposed to have the girl on the phone, his girlfriend, on Thursday.
I just got a note. Eric is sick, so he is not calling in today. Maybe that's why you don't... He also sounds like he has a cold.
Yeah, I said he sounds like he's strangled
or something. Up.
Is Eric changing his clothes, or is he like Richard?
Ah. See, Eric the Midget, Idle Commentary... Want one more? I mean, I got 20 of them. Hey, J.D., which are the best ones?
Why haven't we had the girlfriend on yet?
Yeah, where is that girlfriend? Maybe he's right.
You know, to be honest, the whole show is the same thing over and
it
over.
It is.
Yeah, it's like...
There's no standout moment.
No, I mean, the one I thought the funniest one was he talks about the interns fucking with him. But it's more like the back office fucking with him.
I see.
Just to get his reaction on the webcam.
I'll just play any of these.
Okay,
I don't know.
Yeah, just they're all the same.
Listen, Lisa in the room would like to know, what do you think Howard surprises for you? Have you even thought about that?
Oh, that's what it was that I was going to tell you.
What's that? Hey, Moggy.
Hey, Moggy.
They actually let Johnny in on it.
Oh.
What it was they were going to surprise me that they could get Kendra on the show.
No, that isn't the surprise.
No, why would that be the surprise?
That's it.
That was the extent of their surprise.
No, that's not the surprise, stupid. Now he's annoying me.
That's not the prize, dum-dum.
Oh, this show is the best show I've ever heard. It is absolutely insane.
And it's so funny.
Who's the woman? Where'd they find her?
I don't know. She actually sounds like maybe she's had some sort of radio experience.
Oh, look, here comes security. Oh, I love the lunacy.
No, there's no more lunacy than what's going on right
See,
on that show.
The thing that doesn't work is she's too polished.
No.
They need another American Idol fanatic sitting there talking to Eric.
Here's Eric watching the show and commenting.
What the hell?
That's it?
No,
I can't believe this is almost the end of the show. They end with this. Alrighty.
Watch him be like have a really good voice. That would be too funny.
What's going on? That's some connection.
They picked him. Hopefully you wouldn't continue to look like that.
Sounds like our broadcast from Vegas when we worked at K-Rock.
This is what an internet radio show sounds like?
Yeah. Jeez. Well, that's what Eric's show sounds like. Hey, Frank in Philadelphia, you're on the air.
Hey, how you doing, Howard? Hey, listen, you ever see that Lord of the Rings, that Smeagol? That's what he sounds like.
He's Smeagol.
You know what it reminds me of, Howard? I don't know how far you got into the book, but that Confederacy of Dunces, the character Ignatius O'Reilly, he's basically the biggest asshole, pompous, like, obese guy in the world, and he watches, like, an American Bandstand type show, because he sits home all day, and... He just yells at the TV because he hates everybody. Yeah. That's what Eric sounds like. He's just bitter and mad.
No, Eric does not do any drugs.
Or drink.
Eric does nothing.
You know, I find it funny that Stern thinks that these listeners hang on every word of the show, but yet they're still asking questions like that when I've said that many times on air.
I didn't know he didn't drink.
I don't drink or use drugs.
Yeah, but you should know that, Robin.
I'm here and I don't hang on everywhere.
I want to know why he doesn't drink or do any drugs.
You should.
Yeah, why not? I'd be drinking myself into oblivion.
Maybe that proves that while people are listening to the show, they zone out during his speaking.
You know, some people, I guess, you know, maybe they don't listen all the time, or like you said, maybe they're not listening as closely as you think. Wait, hang on 1 second. Be right back.
Right.
Probably has to take a shit.
She's going to the bathroom.
Man. I have to go find
one word. One word. Geek.
Geek.
Wow.
Ever calling a guy a geek.
Wow.
Aw, well, geeks might be able to sing, too.
That looks like a young Bill Gates.
Yeah, wow. Oh, listen to this one.
Doesn't look like a Queen fan, does he?
Not at all, Eric. Not at all.
What a great accompaniment to American
Idol. Wow. Yeah, how did I watch the show last night without this commentary?
Eric, congratulations. What a show.
It was good. It gave me a break. It's only our sixth at night of doing that.
I'm not saying anything negative. I'm saying what a show.
It sucked. It went all the way over to the suck column that it got good.
Yeah. It was
right,
so bad.
It sucked so bad it started to be
yeah.
good again.
The suck meter actually went around in a 360.
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah, and it got...
And it broke on the good side.
It got to good again.
Hey, Artie, 360, isn't that your weight?
There you go. So, Eric, the show is taking off. Do you have any idea of what your ratings were? Did you...
What do the overnights look like?
I mean, can you tell how many people listen to the Eric the Midget, or Eric the Actor show, I should say?
The first night we crashed GoDaddy and Stick'Em.
Really?
So many people.
You crashed GoDaddy.
And Stick'Em.
I see. Now, on the actual show that you do, what do you call yourself? What name do you go by?
Eric the Shithead.
Okay.
No, I go by Eric the Actor.
No, but you just said Eric the Shithead, so I'm not sure. Did you go by Eric the Actor, Eric the Shithead, or did you use another name?
Eric the Jackass.
Oh, okay, all right. Eric, who's that girl that's on the show with you?
That is one of our other JFSC members, Gina.
Yeah, very professional.
What's her name, Meredith?
I said Gina.
Meredith, what's your name?
Clean the shit out of your ears.
Josephine is your name?
What name do you use?
Eric, the piece of crap.
Right.
No.
What name do you use, if not Eric, the piece of crap?
Eric, the butt fucker.
Wow.
That's a good one, Eric.
Meredith sounded...
Well, Meredith did a great job.
She sounded professional.
She sounds a little too good.
Yeah.
It's Gina.
She did a good job.
You should know that.
Yeah, I know her name is Gina, but what name do you use?
Eric, the disrespectful piece of crap. Nope.
No? What name did you use?
Eric, the idiot.
Oh. All right. Now I know. So, what are the plans for the show? Do you plan to get some advertisers?
Possibly, if we can.
No. And by the way, your special surprise that I had for you, which I don't have for you yet, which I don't even know if I'll be able to get, but that had nothing to do with that shit calling in.
Interesting, since I have an inside source, but whatever.
Well, your inside source is wrong. Right, anyway, hey, Penn Jillette's here. I got to go get ready for that. I just
All
wanted
right.
to know what was going on with you.
Okay.
All right, Art.
Bye.
And,
badass.
Yeah, keep doing that shitty show.
You keep doing that shitty show that you're on right now.
Oh, yeah, like you're on a better show than me. And I guess you're the one who fucking graduated from the Connecticut School of Broadcasting.
All right, Eric. And, by the way, what do you want me to call you?
Eric the Asswipe.
I like that one.
Eric the Asswipe.
That's pretty...
I didn't say that.
Well, if you didn't say it, who said it?
An audio clip that you punched in.
No. All right. Well, do me a favor then. Tell me what you want me to call you.
Eric the Asswipe.
What did you say?
Eric the Bastard.
All right. I don't think those are respectful names, but Eric, I don't know. I just don't know. Are you still there?
Yeah.
All right. Hey, Eric, anyway, congratulations on your show. And if you want to watch Eric, he's on, what is that website you're on?
www.jssc.tv.
All right.
Hey, Eric, how do you and Meredith prepare for the show every day? Do you suck at something for 4 hours and then go on? Like, do you practice by sucking at something else and then...
You mean he practices sucking?
Right. Like they are,
he's gotten so good at it.
Like, you pick something else that he sucks at, which would be like anything, like singing or something, and then you suck at it for 4 hours, and then you guys go right on the air and suck. You're in the middle of prime
time. You're at top sucking.
Right.
Level.
Hey, let me ask you a real question. Eric, were you surprised that the kid who looked like Bill Gates actually had a good voice?
Yeah, a bit surprised.
See, there's a real question.
Wow.
Boy, that elicited such emotion.
I've never been so bored.
You've never been so fat either.
You're right. I got to work on it.
Eric, who will win? The New York Giants? Or Green Bay?
Well, since you guys are New York fans, I'll go with New York.
All right.
Oh, wow, thank you. Very nice of you.
I don't know. You know, I'm not hopeful. I want to see the Giants win. I'm a Giant fan, but yeah. I really would.
Fuck me, yeah.
I would really be shocked if they won.
The smart money ain't on the Giants, that's for sure. But I'll tell you. Eric, please, suck on your own show. Don't make this show suck.
By the way, Ralph...
Don't worry, you guys already handle that yourself.
Yeah.
Hey, Eric, Ralph wants to give you advice on your show.
Oh, no.
Yes, Ralph, if you have some constructive criticism for... Eric, what is the name you want us to call you?
Eric the Boozer.
All right.
Well, my first piece of advice would be to go with Eric the Shithead. That's what I love.
Yeah, right.
That has a ring to it.
That flows off the tongue.
Eric, you need some color commentary on it a little bit. Like when somebody walks out, describe them a little bit. Say what people are looking at.
Well, they're watching the TV show.
Well, yeah, it's, you know, the what? Purpose maybe is I to watch with.
Wait. Maybe I can't watch the TV show. Maybe I just want to hear Eric.
No.
What pathetic soul's doing that?
I don't think there's anybody just listening to Eric.
I don't think there's anybody listening to Eric.
You know being pathetic, don't you, Artie?
Listen, dude, I'm just saying, what I heard was unbelievably awful radio.
Eric was pretty bad.
Mm.
But it's funny bad, you know.
Do you realize it's funny bad, or you just think it's good, or what's the next step in this whole thing?
Yeah, suppose it gets better and it's just bad.
I think Meredith's going to commit suicide.
Well, JFS, he's actually going to start, hopefully, soon getting celebrity interviews.
Oh. All right.
You moron.
Eric plans on doing those badly, too.
So, on the show, what do you call yourself?
Eric the Shithead.
All right.
That's a clear winner.
I'm sorry, I didn't hear you. What do you call yourself?
Eric the worthless sack of shit.
Okay.
I like that.
All right.
Eric, you're a boob.
Well, Eric,
you've got man boobs.
He's a boob and you have man boobs.
Listen, I can lose weight. You're never going to get taller.
How about that, Eric the boob?
No, all right. Listen, Eric, good luck with the show. We'll speak to you next time. And, Ralph, thank you for the criticism.
Mm.
All right. And Eric is on his way. He's got a little something going. It sounds like a lot of jealous people out there.
Three.
All right. But nevertheless, he's got something going on. He's got his own radio show. Thank you, Eric.
Okay.
All right, bye for now.
Bye.
Ow. Shut up, Ralph.
Who's a hater of Eric, like a player hater? Who's got it worse than Eric? Like,
what do you mean?
I mean, like, you said there's people jealous, but I'm wondering who it would be.
I'm thinking maybe you are.
Oh, okay.
The way you're attacking him.
Actually, you're right, because I don't have my own show.
Right.
He's got his own show.
Yeah. He watches TV all day and hangs out. What do you?
Well, he's turning it into a career. Look at him.
Yeah.
Right, Eric?
Now he's asking people to watch TV with him.
You know, Eric, I was thinking you needed a catchy name for your show. Do you have any ideas?
Eric the Retard.
Okay.
So, I don't like that one. That's overused.
Yeah, I don't like that, Eric. Eric?
That's fine, I didn't say it.
Any other ideas, Eric?
Do you have any other ideas for a name?
Eric, the piece of crap.
How about
That's good.
How about, this is a good name for a show, how about the mind-numbingly dull hour?
All right, listen, I got to get the pen. Eric, whatever you call it, they're just jealous. You've got something going on and they don't. And feel better. What is wrong with you?
It was 2 hours, Artie. Right.
Yeah. What do you, Eric, what do you have wrong with you? What is going on?
I either have a cold or a flu.
All right, well, take care of yourself.
You don't leave the house. How'd you get sick?
Listen, it happens.
What?
You don't leave the house either, Ralph. All right, thank
you. And Ralph
ain't
sick.
Yeah, we're talking to another shut-in.
Ralph the shithead. All right, thank you, Eric, and thank you, Ralph.
Goodbye, shithead.
Boy, Eric, I tell you what, it's got to be annoying that Ralph gets in on every one of your phone calls.
I'm sick of it.
Yeah, I like when you put Eric. Can I just, I'm a big fan of Eric after like 8 o'clock when I get up.
Okay, thank you. Eric. Thank you, Eric.
Please put me on earlier.
Well, okay, and for the record, what do you want to be called on Eric, when you're on the show?
Eric the butt fucker.
Eric, make a final decision on this now.
Final decision right now.
Eric the disrespectful piece of crap.
All right, final decision.
Right. He's seesawing.
All right, Eric. Thank you, and good luck with the show. Seriously.
All right.
And I'm going to try and get this thing together for you, and I'll tell you what it is next week. Bye.
Yeah.
Right, bye.
Okay.
Right. Bye for now.
Bye for now.
Hi, Ralph the idiot.
Ralph the idiot. All right, Ralph the idiot and Eric. The disrespectful piece of shit.
The show, you know, it needs a little work. It's going to start humming, I think.
You sound a little bit jealous.
I am jealous. When I called it mind-numbingly dull, I was clearly jealous.
You could see the kid sounds like he's onto something, yeah. And you're getting a little envious.
You're right, because every thought in my head is negative. Like I was going to say, you could call it the show that'll make you shove needles in your ears hour.
Yes, Mike, in White Plains.
Hey, what's up, guys?
Hey, now.
It sounded like the first lunar landing, that show.
Yeah, like, one small step for man.
It's like the lunar landing. It's like they haven't perfected the phone yet with that show.
All the echo and everything?
Yeah, it's all over the place.
One tiny man for man.
Eric, what do you think? What do you think of the show? The show.
Yeah, the echo was wild.
And this guy sucked.
This guy should have gave up before he started.
That's some show.
As people are like smashing their head into a dashboard.
Everyone died, and he was the only guy who had a show.
I love that Ralph thought there was someone not watching American Idol in that.
And wanting to just hear it from Eric.
I hate these kids who come in and think they're like, what's his name, that Ryan kid and all that. Ugh. Ugh.
That's a song by Little Big Town.
Ugh.
Little Big Town.
He's doing pretty good because this song is done by a quartet. Two guys, two girls.
Wow.
But he needs to do something with the eyebrows. Wow, they're really fucked up eyebrows.
It's a lunar landing.
I mean, yeah, it really is. Like, it sounds like technology got sent back 50 years.
This is the first phone.
One small step for mankind. What a fat guy. And eyebrows are This is the only show podcast with two cans and a string.
You know what it's like? It's like Edison's first recording after he invented the phonograph. Yeah, like, Mary had a little lamb.
Mr. Watson. Are you there?
Yes.
What did Watson say to the?
I thought Edison well, said Mary had a little
Watson,
lamb.
Watson, come here, I need you.
Yeah. Oh.
Watson, come here, I need you.
It's great.
You know what? I want to get tapes of that show. I listen to it all the time.
It's good. I'm going to tune in next week.
You're right. I am jealous.
Yeah, you are. I see. He's got something going on.
Yeah,
here.
See? It's become parody already.
Don't forget, you have stuff going on, too. There's room enough for everyone in show business.
Like obesity.
I got to put that kid in a movie. We're going to take a break. We're going to come back with Penn Jillette, a man you used to date, Robin. Right after these words. Eric the Midget is on the phone. Yes, Eric.
Hello.
Hello. By the way, Eric the Midget's American Idol show was on again, and last night's was the best show ever.
Why was it so good last night?
Well, I'm going to play a little bit. This is Eric the Midget from his show last night.
Stop playing that, please.
That ain't me playing.
I know, it's dumbass Fred.
I hear it's Eric the Midget's Idol show. You got to hear this. This is the best. I think this is the best radio show maybe I've ever heard.
Really?
Wait till you hear this. Now, I'm going to ask you to listen for a while. This clip runs a minute 23, so okay. Don't... You're going to think at points that it might be over the clip, but it's
again,
not. Yes.
You can never tell when this show is on the air.
Here we go. Eric the Actor's Idol Show.
Okay, how's everyone doing tonight? We're on a commercial break at the moment, so when the show returns, obviously I'll be making some comments about the contestants.
Okay, guys, you guys hear him okay? Put a one in the room if you can hear Eric loud and clear. Oh, you requested to tell some jokes like yesterday, Eric. Do you have any jokes?
No.
You guys should work that out ahead of time.
Oh, God, that guy is bad. Okay, too high, slice. Well, that beeping didn't exactly work. You kind of tell it a little bit of what he said.
Bad sense
is just job.
I love when they do that. They skip the, you get half the curse word out on the air.
Yeah.
I bet they won't get fined like Stern does.
Time to tell.
Well, there's a small clip from Eric the Eric the Actor's.
Now, didn't they establish at one point that the reason that echo occurs is because something Eric forgets to push?
I don't know, but it's like a lunar landing to me, that show. It's like...
Oh. This is not for someone's voice.
Eric, you got to be proud of that show.
Why bother to do a show?
Give him something to do.
Why do you bother being a bitch?
Now he hates everybody.
Eric, that is unlistenable.
No, it's not. You guys got
what?
That part of the show. What? Where the hell is the rest of it?
All right, I'll play another clip from it, you, as long as you ask. I'm more than willing to do that.
We have it in our suck file.
Hold on, let me get the suck file out.
The page of things that suck.
Yeah, we have that and a couple of late season Met games from last year.
This is reached the furthest planets.
Ericville.
All right, Eric's right. Why not play more of the show? Here we go. Here's a second clip from Eric, the Actor's great radio show.
All right, guys, we're on a commercial break.
again, want to welcome you guys.
Of course, Eric is here. Do you guys have any questions for him? Put them in the room. Daz wanted to know, I believe, what your last movie
was.
It's absurd.
Oh, you're right, Eric. It got better.
Yeah. Wow, that's amazing. How much more you want to hear?
Guys, hang on a second. Shut up, cackling witch.
Robin's going to pass out.
I wish she would.
Oh, stop it.
Oh, my goodness.
Well, there you go.
That's great, Eric. He's right.
Where is the part of me doing the interview of Jason Hervey? That was
You know what? I never got that far. It was kind of difficult. I think by then most people were out.
Your Jason Hervey interview is too deep in the suck file to dig out.
I mean, my God, Eric. I mean, what an embarrassment. I mean, you got to get on these people and bust some balls here. It's your name on the show.
You're chasing people away.
I mean, this is crazy.
It's better than any Ron and Fez I've ever heard.
By the way, what name did you go by? I know sometimes you switch your names. What name did you go by last night on the show?
Eric the Fag.
Oh, all right.
Short but sweet.
That's some show.
Are you proud of it?
Eric did finally get... Yes! How are your ratings?
Pretty good.
Yeah.
They're up to minus 40.
People must not
That's
be able
your
to
IQ,
believe it.
Isn't it?
Their temperature's
yes,
higher. The temperature's higher than the last one. Well, here, Eric the actor tells a joke. This is from a few shows ago. I never got to here. This is one I can at least come up with a show where they didn't have so many technical problems. Here he is telling a joke.
Oh yeah, it's a commercial break. We got to hear those jokes.
Oh yeah. All right, let me start off with the one I did at the Killers of Comedy that I heard off of the Girls Next Door. Okay. The joke was, a little boy said to his mom one day, "Mom, where do babies come from?" And the mom says, "Well, they come from the stork." So the kid says to her then, "Okay, then who fucked the stork?"
Yeah, I thought that was pretty good.
Timing might be a little bit of a problem.
Compared to the other one.
I'm curious, Eric, who fucked the stork? What happened?
That's true, too. Well, Eric, thank you so much. What name did you go by last night?
Eric the Ignorant Asshole.
Well, that might explain some of the technical difficulties.
Eric, I'm watching you on your screen right now. Who is the girl in the upper right-hand corner?
That is my co-host, Gina.
Oh!
Is that why Gina's putting her hand over the camera lens so that she doesn't have to be seen?
I don't see her hand going over the camera lens.
Hey, she's cute.
She's very cute.
Very cute.
Let's see your co-host's, I don't know, ass or something?
Tell her to show us her tits. Hey, what does she call you on the show?
Eric the Shitty Penis.
That's my favorite,
that's
Eric.
A sweet name.
The Shitty Penis. Because it makes you assume something about Eric.
I'm in the anal.
What's that name you like, Eric?
Eric the Butt Fucker.
Oh. Mm-hmm.
Now that's what it makes you think, the Shitty Penis.
All right, Eric.
Does Eric have anything to say? Is there something he wanted us to know today or anything?
Like what?
No, I just wondered. You called in.
He did want us to know something. He wants us to call him by a different name.
Okay.
Eric the shithead.
All right.
Eric, who painted your hair today?
I think he's letting it go gray, actually.
Is it? That's,
yeah.
Yeah,
you should
really do
it. No, I'm not.
When do you get it touched up?
hopefully soon.
Yeah, okay. It's going a little gray to my eye.
Eric, what the... I don't know how specific you can get with this, but you're in Northern California, right?
Correct.
I have to book a gig...
You want to be near him.
I have to go meet him. I have to go. Eric, if I did a gig out in Northern California, A, would you come? And B, can I come see your setup there?
Can you see your pillow?
He wants to visit you.
Yeah.
Well, I know that Jim Levy's supposed to do a show here in Sacramento.
No, fuck him. I'm talking about me. I want to come by and see your whole setup.
Well, I'm saying if you, like, joined him.
I don't want to join him.
He wants to do his own thing.
He's willing to book a gig so he can come hang out.
Yeah, I want to see your whole setup there. Is that allowed?
Yeah, I guess so. There's the punchline that's in the area.
All right. I'm going to try to do that. We'll let you know. I want to be a guest on your show.
I don't do stand-up, but I might book a show.
You're going to be on his internet show?
I mean, I got to see it. Now I have to see it. It's like my favorite show. I'm curious to see the setup. You know what I mean?
We're actually through Jason and Herbie. We're actually working on getting other celebrity interviews.
Well, Artie will be a guest.
Tell Jason Irvin to keep his paws off our channels. You and Bubba, come on.
All right, Eric. Congratulations on another fine show.
And, can Artie sit in your chair?
Congratulations.
And break it.
His white ass going to fit in here.
All right. Thank you, Eric. And good luck with the show. And I'm sure you'll be doing it again next week. And where can people see you again?
At www.jfsc.tv.
All right. Thank you.
Oh, Gina said that she loves Artie.
Yes. Well, he's attracted to her, too. Thank you. Thank you very much. Johnny, what do you have for us?
I gave him the ratings to, I just gave him the will, the password and everything, but when you see what Eric has done, you guys aren't going to believe it.
What has he done?
Well, take a guess what you think the number could be in the last 3 weeks.
I mean, how many people tune in for his show?
Yeah.
I don't know.
No, how many people? How many hits? The hits.
Hits.
Oh, okay. You know what? Because of the exposure on our show.
Right. Of course.
I bet it could be a couple hundred thousand, maybe.
Yeah. How about 13 million?
What?
Eric has 13 million hits?
I just gave Will the password and the way to get in, and he's got 13, he's got almost 14 million hits.
Well, no, it hits. Our hits. 14 million hits must equal four people.
Yeah.
No. It means that 14 million people checked it out?
No, it means that...
No, it means that either four people checked it out 14 million times, or...
There's somebody on there.
People. But no, Howard, this thing is jammed up day and night, and you've got people that are just leaving it on their browsers.
Well, I believe it, because I love watching it. I mean, it's fascinating.
But, well, Johnny, what about the technical problems?
Well, I don't know. Fuck, I don't know nothing about it. I mean, I wasn't even that interested until I saw the numbers.
I wouldn't switch anything. Start selling advertising.
All right, Johnny, thank you. Today is that he hates the Howard 100 News team and wants to get rid of them. Robin, you do too, don't you?
Yes, I'm on Eric's side.
Uh-oh.
Right. Let's have a syndicate.
Are you going to put out a hit?
Eric, hello. Sorry, Eric.
I said good morning.
Good morning. All right. Why do you hate the Howard 100 News team? I don't have much time, so let's get right to it.
Well, because when we had Kendra on the show, you know, the JFSC, and she got on the phone with Johnny and got on air with you, Gary promised Johnny that Kendra would not be bugged by anybody.
No, that's not what I said to little midget. I didn't say that.
Yeah.
First of all, you don't know what was said because you were trying to keep her off the show. So there's no agreement that involves you.
Johnny,
I said that when we had Kendra on, I'm talking, Shorty. I said that when we had Kendra on, we would treat her nicely, and we did.
Johnny told me that you told him that you would leave her completely alone.
That was never said. We never said that. We said we would be nice to her when she called in. And we were. And we are still nice to her. It's the Howard 100
News. What happened? He's mad about talking about the picture.
Yeah.
No. That doesn't mean they're not nice. There's a picture. So what?
Fake story. That completely fucking fake story.
What's Howard? Eric got a new camera. I don't know if you can see.
Ooh.
But it's a little bit clearer. You can really see the zits now. Look at all that shit.
There is no zits, you shithead.
Wow, that picture is good.
And he did his hair yesterday.
You can really see you now, Eric, on that JFSC.
And yeah, it's a different angle.
It's amazing that you could get even odder looking.
Wow, you
can
really see.
Yeah, you should talk about being odd looking, ape boy.
Ooh.
Hey, when are they going to get it so that, like Eric's lips move simultaneously with what he's saying?
You know, Tony, I have a webcam that I use with my kid, and it's perfect. It's perfect streaming video. I don't know what he's using as a source to stream the video. That might be it.
He's still, like, a little bit choppy, you know what I mean? But, wow, that's such a clear picture. What, they just bought a better camera?
I guess so, yeah.
No, it's my roommate's laptop.
Is it a different... Oh, it's your roommate's laptop. You never used that one before, right?
Right, I used it for the show last night.
Yeah, that is a much better camera than yours.
Yeah, call that camera the zit cam.
Yeah, Eric, you do have a lot of zits.
Someone in the room just typed, no zits, motherfucker.
Oh, so then it must be true.
Then what's that stuff on your face? Seriously, on your cheek, right to the...
On the left.
Like the left of your nose.
On your chin.
There's a, like, there's, and on your chin, there's like a big...
By his nose,
That, right here?
Yeah, what's that?
It's clearing up.
Okay.
And what about that one on your chin? Take a look at that.
There's nothing.
Oh.
Right on the bottom. Yeah, that.
Another one clearing up. But they're not.
So they're not zits. They used to be.
That like one of those Gorbachev stains on his forehead?
Yeah, there's a big red.
Oh. Just above the right eye.
You could circle it right here. Circle, yeah. Eric, circle this big red blotch on your... Right here. You see it? I'm circling it on my screen.
It's like a map of Africa.
Yeah. What is that?
Nothing.
How come it's always red up there? Is that a stain?
No.
What is it?
Well, what is it? You see it.
You just heard me. I said it's nothing.
You don't see anything.
You're just red in certain spots.
It might be from that hair dye you're using. It might be running into your head.
No, it's... I'm probably red out of anger.
Oh, red out of anger. Okay, all right. Well, that makes sense.
So you said there was a fake story? What was the fake story?
I got the clear story from her yesterday. She never asked him back to her place. She never held his hand, and she was never all over him.
So they photoshopped that picture?
I guess.
Mm-hmm. Well, but I don't know about that. Well, Gary wants to tell you something.
You know, listen, I'm talking to the Howard 100 News Department. They're saying the story's totally true. And, Eric, think about it for a second. I know you don't have a lot of experience with women.
But
if that did happen... Wouldn't she lie to you about it?
Lie detector, that motherfucker. It's not true.
Lie detector what, motherfucker?
The guy that said he was holding a hand.
The jackass that did it.
How about lie detecting Kendra?
There you go.
I trust her.
Eric, did it ever dawn on you that she might not always tell you the truth because she doesn't want to hurt your little feelings?
Not true. She's not lying to me. I know it.
Little person, big feelings, Gary.
He's headed for a major fall. You know what I mean?
Man.
Like, I feel bad. He's going to be heartbroken.
Why do you trust her so much? You hardly know her.
I just do.
He loves her.
He's going to cry.
All right, don't cry.
No, I'm not going to cry.
That new camera, I can see the tears rolling.
Yeah.
There's no tears, jackass. I don't know what the fuck you're looking at.
All right, we'll stop talking
about it. Hey, just real quick. Eric the Midget's show last night. This is his American Idol show. It was, again, fascinating.
Yeah, are you still fascinated with American Idol? It is so boring at this point.
Yeah, I actually turned it off. I was tired.
Yeah.
I couldn't deal with it. But here is Eric. If you want a little taste of what Eric was up to during the Idol show, here he is with his co-hostess. And they are deep in conversation and analysis of American Idol.
Paula is useless. She's just there to make everybody feel good and say yes when they really suck.
She's too high to prowl. She's too high to prowl.
What? I don't know who's more.
Ever seen Paula Abdul in person, but she looks crazy.
She looks like she's gonna cut the girl 18 years old.
Eric will answer your questions, like general questions, after the show. No problem. We'll have a Q&A session.
What is going on this week?
Right.
It's like a NASA lunar landing.
It is Mars Attack.
Look, there's better audio from the moon.
You can't make out one word Eric's saying. They said he'll answer your questions after the show.
I can't wait for that part. Eric, fabulous radio.
We did a much better job last night.
But you can't hear it. You did a better job for you and whoever you were in the room with.
You picked the fucking clip where four people were trying to talk at once.
Well, what clip should I hear? I'll pull another clip, okay? Here.
Not the correct word to say in here, jackass.
I think in this clip, Eric is yelling at some kid in the chat room.
Okay.
Yeah, King needs to mod up some people. I don't know if he's on mic there, John, if you could tell him.
Yeah, I'm not modded. Hey, Ram, shut the fuck up.
And Eric's yelling.
Get the fuck out.
Yeah, Eric is actually reading it and watching the show.
Wow. Well, there's another clip of... Oh, wait.
Yeah, the bad part is I can't kick anyone right at the moment.
All right, there it is. Another exciting part of Eric's radio show.
Wow.
What was that we just listened to?
I'm not a mod. I can't kick him out. Eric is actually reading and watching.
That's clearing up. That's another one that's clearing up.
That's some radio show. I mean, if they could at least...
You know, they're Eric, taking radio backwards.
Eric, you can't talk to a guy in a chat room over your radio show, and no one else knows what the fuck is going on. I mean, come on, if I can give you some pointers, I'm pretty good at this stuff.
Radio is going backwards with them. You know, you can hear radio.
Want to hear another clip or no?
Yes.
You do? I haven't heard these. All right, maybe this is a good one.
There is some oddball trying out for in Atlanta. What the? A geeky looking woman with.
I like that Eric makes fun of how the people look.
Geeky looking.
Yeah. You would think Eric would be sensitive to how people look.
Hello, I'm trying to paint a visual for the East Coasters, which had the show over for 3 hours.
Okay. Just not nice.
Paint away.
Just not nice to call somebody geeky. You know. No answer to that.
Eric, a regular Picasso with words.
Don't you think it could hurt their feelings when you call them geeky?
Yeah, like they're really listening.
Yeah, let us hurt their feelings. That's our job.
At least Eric's aware that nobody's listening.
Trying to do a rap song and she was actually cursing.
A rap?
Oh, no.
Well, there it is. That's another clip from Eric's show. I hope you enjoyed it.
I don't know if I consider that better than last week.
I think they took a step backwards myself. No offense, Eric. I think last week's show might have been better.
Or our sound with this laptop is better than a sound on my computer.
I see. Hey, by the way, what name did you go by last night?
Eric the Bastard.
Oh. Wow.
Shortened it up.
That you didn't call yourself Eric the Bastard, did you?
No.
What did you call yourself?
Eric the Buttfucker.
Eric the Buttfucker? I thought you didn't like gay sex acts.
I don't.
Right.
Why'd you call yourself that?
Why'd you call yourself that?
That goes along with Eric the Shitcock, too.
Right. So what did you call yourself last night?
Eric the Shitty Penis.
Oh, Shitty Penis, yeah. Look at him. He's got the phone going. He's on the computer. He's like a CEO. Look at how busy he is.
Like Mitt Romney.
Yeah.
You look like Mitt Romney. Anyone ever tell you that?
My technical person just texted me, said, it's not radio.
What is it?
He's listening to it and is listening to you guys in his car, and he told me to tell you that...
I don't know what you're talking about, and I can't imagine what it's like to be your technical person, but...
You called it radio.
Okay, well, right. You're taking television backwards, then.
Then you take... whatever you're doing, it's backwards. It's gone backwards.
Just give us the name of the technology you're ruining.
Yeah, what technology are you ruining?
We'll say that.
What technology are you using? If it's not radio.
We are using, like I've said before, Stick'em, GoDaddy.com.
What does that mean?
And Ventrilo.
So you're not doing radio?
No.
It's television. It's internet television?
Right.
Oh. Okay, then all you're right. Taking that back.
You're ruining internet television.
All right, so then what the hell are you calling yourself on internet television?
Eric the Black of Shit.
All right. Well, then I'll make sure to view it. All right, Eric, thank you, and I appreciate your coming on the show.
Also, by the way, Mutt told you a sack of shit yesterday. Until yesterday, his name was on the list of the syndicate members.
All right, well, maybe we'll save that for another time.
He removed it.
Well, then he's not a member of the syndicate. Maybe he didn't know his name was there.
I don't think Mutt's a member of the syndicate.
He was until yesterday. I just said that.
I don't know. Maybe it was a mistake. I don't think he's a member of the syndicate. All right. Eric,
we
thank you.
We really don't care if he's
You don't care if Mutt is a member of the syndicate? I care. Everyone cares.
I don't care.
You're probably the only person in America that doesn't care.
High Pitch wanted me to say that he is going to be DJing on here tonight.
Oh, my God.
Oh, good. Okay. Hey, by the way, what does High Pitch call you?
Eric, the ignorant asshole.
Oh, okay.
No, I don't. Don't fall for that, Eric.
Eric's going to DJ.
Wow. All right. Hey, Eric, I got to go, and I congratulate you on your new camera. It's much, much better.
Thank you.
All right. Good luck with your show tonight. Eric will be on tonight on JFSC. Something.
That's another American Idol night.
Right. Hello?
Hello.
Yeah, what can I do for you?
Well, I was calling to see if JD, number one, recorded the show on Friday that I did.
Yeah, I haven't heard it. Let's see. Eric the Midget Country Show on the Eric the Midget Commentary page.
Idol Commentary page.
Yeah, this is your country show? I've never heard this.
It's just as bad as the normal show.
It is bad? What's the best track to play as an example of how bad it is?
Well, I mean, the first clip, he starts out okay. Like, he does, you know, however you say, hit the post.
Oh, really?
He hits his post, sort of.
Okay, again, that was Phil Stacy with If You Didn't Love Me. Now we have Julianne Hough with The Song in My Head.
You were hanging.
First of all, do you realize, if I'm correct, Phil, what's the guy's name? Phil Stacy? Isn't he from American Idol?
Correct.
Yeah.
And oh, so are all of your artists American Idol artists?
He was that bald guy who was one of the losers on American Idol last season. And then the next one is Julianne Hough, who's a dancer on Dancing with the Stars.
I was doing the top 30.
Top 30 where?
29.
Oh, yeah? Is Phil Stacy in the top 30?
Yeah.
And Julianne Hough is in the top 30?
The date was May 3rd. That's when that was started.
You're a regular Tiny Kasem.
May 3rd, 2012?
No, this year.
Hey, by the way, a lot of people don't know this, but Eric was just a guest on Inside the Actor's Studio. He's being honored by...
Really?
Yeah. This is set to air in a couple of weeks. Ooh. Here is Eric with the host of Inside the Actor's Studio.
James Lipton.
James Lipton. Thank you, Robin.
What is your favorite word?
Shit cock.
What is your least favorite word?
Kendra.
Now the question that the world has been waiting for. What turns you on?
Your father's cock.
What turns you off?
Disrespectful piece of crap. Midgets like me.
If heaven exists, what would you like to hear God say when you arrive at the pearly gates?
You're going to feel something big in your asshole.
Very good. That's just a clip from an entire hour.
I can't wait to see the whole hour.
That's right. So we want to give a shout out to that.
I wonder what God would put in his asshole.
Eric, congratulations on that honor.
I wasn't on that show.
Oh, you weren't? Someone told me you were going to be on for an hour.
We just played a tape from it.
Tapes don't lie, Eric.
By the way, if you look on Eric's camera, he shaved his mustache. I don't know if you noticed. He looks 100 times better.
He kept some scruff, though, at the bottom.
Yeah, that's still there. He looks Amish at this point.
Well, because what he's got to do is now trim that down, that scruff underneath, and just have a little bit of it, a little patch.
Yeah, but why is it, it's almost under his chin.
Yeah, it's like Planet of the Apes. Remember the apes had, like, little beards? Yeah, Eric, I know what you're going for with that facial hair. Like, you shaved off the mustache, that was smart, but you see the thing on your chin?
Yes.
You got to kind of trim it a little bit, like, and you do that with an electric razor.
I know.
And you need to leave a little bit of it on the front. You know, it's like a little too much under your chin.
You're almost like a billy goat.
Yeah. You're billy goating. All right, but anyway, what made you shave off the mustache? Did you agree that we were right about it?
Kind of.
Yeah. You knew it was a bad mustache.
Yeah.
All right.
How are the eyebrows doing? Are they coming back?
I think so.
Now you should shave your face off.
Can we get a good look at the eyebrows to see if they're cut? Because he shaved his eyebrows. Can you lift that hat a little bit?
Hang on.
All right. There he goes.
There's a little bit of a time delay on
right.
Site.
Yeah, they're coming back in.
Yeah.
He does have some weird-ass eyebrows.
Is that anything that's weird?
Could you imagine?
Shut up, geek.
God, wow. Imagine God doesn't even give you normal eyebrows. What a fucker. God already gave it to you in the ass, Eric. Fuck that.
Calling J.D. a geek is great.
Yeah.
Yeah, well.
I like that. He could put you in your place.
I know. Sorry.
Look at all that San Francisco Giants shit, man. I mean.
When did he change to a Giant really? Fan?
Yeah, I thought you were an Oakland A's fan.
I'm a fan of both teams.
All right, JD, what other clips are good from his country show?
You know, there's various clips of where the music is louder than him and where he keeps talking over the people singing.
Good.
That was Jules' debut.
Why do you think this is bad, Jay?
Wow.
This is the best show I've ever heard.
Wow. Eric!
Eric, why? Don't you realize you're not being heard? Who's engineering the show with the music?
I was doing the whole thing myself.
And you can't hear that? We can't hear you over the music?
I can hear, because if the way it's set up, I can't hear what's going on.
Wow.
Oh. Good setup.
That sounds like a perfect disaster. All right, here is Eric bantering during his country show.
Okay, this song is by a group that I really like. It's called Lady Antebellum, and the song is called Love Don't Live in the Living
Room. Not even close to the post.
He's still going. Eric.
We can't hear your shit banter over the shit music.
Or is anything but a shit song, fat ass.
I don't understand.
Yeah, but when you're talking through it, it is.
I don't understand. You know, I've won a few awards in my career. Billboard Award, the Radio Record Award. I've won awards. I understand this business. This is a very unusual approach to radio. I mean.
Yeah, no approach at all.
Yeah, like, what is this? I mean, I don't understand what this is. We can't hear what you're saying. How do you get the music? Where does the music come out of? An iPod or a...
No, one of my computers. I have an external hard drive with all my CDs on it.
And you can't hear...
How hot the music is.
You can't even put on headphones and hear what's going on.
No.
Wow. Amazing.
And you're perfectly happy with that. Are you glad it sounds this way?
Do you think this is good?
Well, I wasn't... aware of it, kind of like that.
So what are you going to do now?
Maybe you should start taping your own show and listening to it. Yeah, and what are you going to do now that you're aware? and can I give you advice? And don't think I'm being cruel. I think you should stick to acting. You're not cut out for radio.
I mean, I didn't know one thing he said.
No.
Maybe he did say something good, but I don't know.
No, let's try another clip. Maybe you can hear him on this one.
Like Christopherson would do.
I like the sound of him coming back on the air with the mic, but sounds like a hurricane. You don't hear that click.
There it is.
I've got a cold beer in my right hand, and my left, I got my wedding
band. Can you hear him?
No, I can't hear him.
I'll give him this. He doesn't bore you. Like, if you're into the music, he's talking way underneath it.
I'm into the songs. I want to know, what would Christopherson do from that last song?
I don't know. It's a new Tim McGraw song.
I'll tell you what I like about your show. It's commercial free. There's no commercials, Robin, if you've noticed.
Well, who would buy a commercial?
Eric, do you write out your breaks, or is it spontaneous?
No, I don't really have any breaks.
He just says, like, the name of the song and the artist. That's it, in between songs.
Yeah, but we can't hear it. I wouldn't know what he's saying.
Singing kaya, diggy, diggy, kaya, diggy, diggy, yay, yay.
I love that.
Wow.
This song is It Ain't a Crime by Joe Nichols.
I was sitting outside in the front yard.
And by the way, I've lost count as to where the countdown is at.
You lost count in the countdown?
Yeah.
My goodness.
You lost count.
This is the whole purpose of doing it. It's a countdown.
Did right. Casey Kasem ever lose count? No.
So we have no idea what number that song is.
Now you lost count in the countdown, but it really wouldn't matter because you can hear it anyway.
How about a long-distance dedication, like Casey?
Eric, how do you work out payments to, you know, for royalties for the music that you use? Like, I know Sirius has to pay X amount of dollars a year for using music to ASCAP and things like that. Well, how do you work that out?
Oops.
I was not aware we had to.
That's what I figured.
We'll be sending some people over there later.
Now, you can't break Eric's legs.
No, well, it's very official. They'll just be arresting him.
I don't think, actually, they'll be bothering Eric.
Oh, my goodness.
Hey, Eric, I don't know. Do you know who Steven Spielberg is, Eric?
Yes, I'm aware of who he is.
Supposedly he's on the phone and wants to offer you a part. Hold on. Mr. Spielberg?
Yeah, how are you, Howard?
Hi. What do you have to say to Eric, and I'll let you talk to him?
Yes, I'd like to offer Eric the movie role called Eric Flies the Balloons.
Because
Eric the Actor is a great person, and I love his show.
You fat loser.
Fuck you, little midget. I'll offer you a movie role. You don't want to take it?
High pitch. Go where you belong.
It's high pitch.
High pitch. This is Steven Spielberg.
Is this high pitch or is it Steven Spielberg?
It's Steven Spielberg.
You know what, Howard? I agree with Eric. There's no way High Pitch could do an impression that good of Spielberg.
Right.
This is Steven Spielberg.
Mr. Spielberg, thank you for calling in. I guess Eric's not taking the job.
All right, whatever. Good luck, Eric.
Are you going to stay in radio, Eric?
Hey, Mr. Spielberg, can you prove it's you? I know you have a black kid. Can you put him on the phone for a second so we know it's
yes,
him?
Yes, hold on. All right. Hey, Sean, come here.
Shorty.
Hey, what's up, man? It's Steven's son.
What's your name?
I'm a little black man.
You're a little black man?
Yeah.
All right, there he is. That is Steven Spielberg, Robin.
It's a quick way to...
I knew he was going to get stumped. I was hoping he said, what's his name?
I thought he was going to say Steven Jr. All right, hey, Joey, thanks.
I'm marrying Eric, High Pitch Eric, and killing Jeff Levy.
Hey, honestly, Eric the Midget, your whole segment got hijacked by High Pitch.
Yeah, I noticed that.
Okay, live with High Pitch or listen to Eric's country show every day.
Hey, Howard,
live with High Pitch.
Did you show Eric how it's done? Has a DJ on the radio?
Let me hear Eric's show. Wait a sec. I'll find one more.
He's critiquing it now.
I think you went back to the beginning.
No.
Oh, yeah, you're right.
Cool. Okay, this playlist is the females of country, and starting off with Shania Twain, Don't Be Stupid.
We kind of hit that one. He did pretty good on that one.
Yeah, I could actually hear him. But what this playlist? What are you talking about? Yeah,
that's after 2 hours of this countdown or whatever. After I heard another playlist was coming up, I stopped.
What are you doing, Eric?
Poor Jimmy.
The night before, I set up several playlists to play on the computer while I do my show.
This is me you're talking to. Okay, now we have
every other Friday.
It's Toys and Clothes.
It's a duet by Reba McEntire.
Is everybody in okay? Let's go see today.
26.
Same time in the same spot. Eric, because of the camera, I can watch your face while you listen to this. You almost seem proud of it.
No.
I mean, it's pretty bad. Even you know, you're a guy who criticizes American Idol and the singers and all that other stuff. And I mean, you've got to hear how bad this is. I mean, surely you realize it. You have an opinion.
Do you really think this is what you should be doing with your life?
Well, hopefully next week will be better.
Don't you think there's something out there that you suck at a little less?
I don't know if this is your calling.
No. But I'm thinking again, Howard, about what you just said. With those choices, Levy and High Pitch, I probably would just commit suicide.
Right. Well, I like that Robin would have sex with Jeff the Drunk.
Because, well, you're forcing me.
Yeah.
I mean, because I'm remembering the tape. Let me see if I can find it. This is a girl who gave... here, Gary Page 1 in blue. Hold on. Take me a second to find it. But here is a girl, the porn actress, Cindy Crawford. She actually agreed to have sex... with, you know,
Jeff
the Drunk.
This was the time in Vegas, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
And here's what she sounded like after having sex with him. This is for real.
It's okay. Sit up. That's Isaac.
Yes.
It's horrible.
Isaac was trying to comfort her.
Yeah.
But he was still holding
and
that
Jeff's
camera.
Laying in bed with a big smile.
So I was like, all right.
He's not saying anything.
Do you remember when he was handcuffed to the chick the first time he shits? The girl, like, Jeff is shitting, and she's got her hand cuffed, you know, and she's outside the bathroom, and she starts to throw up because of the smell, I guess. And yeah. Jeff gets his feelings hurt, and he goes, are you throwing up? Oh, is everything all right?
Hold on, Howard. Sadie almost got away.
Sadie, shut up. I would have a neighbor at the door who's listening to the show on Sirius.
You have a neighbor at the door?
He has Sirius in his room, and that's why he's knocking on my door, because he thinks it's funny.
Oh, yeah?
I was on the show before.
Oh, yeah, he was on the show before.
With his twin brother.
Well, that sounds like a fun place to live. Yeah. It's almost like Friends.
Yeah.
It's almost like Friends.
I think I smell the next series for Howard TV. Like High Pitch and his buddies at the rooming house.
Smellrose Place.
All the guys hanging out and, you know, doing different fun things.
No, if you want to send Howard TV over here on the weekend.
Yeah. All right. All right, well, thank you, Erics. Both Erics. Thank you, Erics. And thank you, and please thank Steven Spielberg for me and his son. Goodbye,
Steven. Come on, Eric.
Howard, don't hang up on me yet.
No, I got to go, Eric.
Now, bye.
Listen, Eric, he's got to go, okay? He's got to get at least a dream.
So you clearly have no idea what an entertaining radio show is.
I was going to say, don't tell him what to do. He knows how to run a
right.
radio show.
I got to go to work, but you guys have a good day.
All right, you too. All right, Eric, thank you. Eric the Midget.
I have a reason to talk to you.
Bye, Eric. See you later.
The radio show.
Thanks, man.
All right, quickly, what is it you have to say? I have to go.
Okay, well, if you didn't let Fat Fuck on.
Bye.
Would have had more time. I wanted to say that if you guys are wanting to take this movie Taxi Driver serious, why in the fuck haven't I gotten a script from that Collins?
Because it's clearing legal. I told you that. All right, I got to go. Thank you, Eric.
You know anything about the production process?
Hold on a minute.
What?
Also, why? The other reason I've been wondering is why haven't I gotten any discussion about pay?
Because there is none. It's a chance for you to act.
You're getting the same thing Colin's getting.
Right.
You're getting the same thing you get for every gig you do.
Nada.
The same as your internet show.
I get paid for that.
Bullshit.
I get paid.
What do you get paid? You don't get paid anything.
I can't discuss that, but I get paid.
Really?
Plus, I do get paid when I show up. For the killers of comedy.
Yeah. Well, this job, you get nothing.
You're getting $80 less a week than JD for taping your show.
Thank you, Eric.
Do I really have to keep recording these shows?
Yes,
we
keep recording.
We want the Idol show this week.
Les Miserables.
This is a big Idol show for Eric. It's coming down to the finals.
Yeah.
All right. Thank you, Eric. We'll talk to you again soon. Bye for now.
All right. Bye.
There you go. Talk of pay.
There's been no talk of pay.
Of most in the world.
That's a new achievement for you, Jimmy.
Eric, quickly, and I do mean quickly, why do you hate
quickly.
Our super fan contestant, Jimmy Kimmel?
Because of the call that one morning after I visited his studio.
Eric, I want you to know that I have a picture of you on my computer, and I look at it all the time. And I marvel at it.
Do you have a picture with him with his shaved eyebrows?
No, his eyebrows look normal in the picture. Yeah, it was a little while ago.
Is this a pre-mustache or post-mustache?
This is pre-mustache.
Pre-mustache.
Yeah, so I believe that he took one of the eyebrows and put it over his lip. He didn't actually shave them. Rearrange his face.
I love that I'm getting to see Eric for the first time.
There he is. Eric right there, Jeff.
Can I just say something to Eric?
Jerry O'Connell.
I think he is... I think he's balking at doing this Colin Quinn film.
Yes.
Because he's a little nervous about maybe his first foray into acting. I know he's a super agent now and those things, but he's he's never really delved into acting.
You are an excellent actor.
I would be willing to go over with maybe Howard TV and maybe help him with some of his lines and give him some pointers to maybe help him gain some confidence. I would be very willing to do that.
Is there any chance he would appear in Taxi Driver with Eric as a co-star?
That is going to be a question I'm probably going to have to ask one of my agents or managers.
I would definitely be Jimmy,
you would appear in the film.
Absolutely.
You say that without asking any agents or managers.
No, I don't even have any.
Yeah.
I commit right now to being in that film.
Well, no one was looking for you.
Eric, you've got a coach now. Is that making you feel more confident?
That's cool. You know, Jerry Maguire was a pretty good movie.
Thank you.
In what?
I would be willing to go over and help him out a little bit. I just think maybe we'll just go over the script and talk about some points and stuff, and I'll give you some of my tricks.
Well, I'll tell you what, Jerry O'Connell does a thing on the internet. He does an impression of Tom Cruise that is dead on. Have you guys seen that?
That's funny.
Good.
It is fantastic.
I have to give a lot of credit to Artie Lang's former coworker Jerry Minor, who is an avid listener and listening right now, who really helped me out with that. It was really.
You see, Eric, everyone gets help. There's no shame in it. Even Jerry O'Connell.
Jerry, can you give Eric a tip now? You say he has some tricks.
You are going to have to listen to your co-actors. If you listen to them, it will really help you.
Why do you have to listen, Jerry?
It will give you a natural performance. I'll tell you, when I did Stand By Me in 1985.
That was a good movie, too.
Thank you.
Eric's a critic now.
The first scene that we shot.
And you were about the height of Eric at that time.
He's a tick.
We were shooting the first scene, and I was standing off to the side, and they were doing a dramatic scene, the other actors, and Rob Reiner yelled, cut, and came over to me in front of everyone and went, what are you doing back here? What are you doing? And I went, well, what do you mean? And he went, you're just standing here. What are you doing? And I went, I'm not in the scene. I'm not saying anything. And he went, you got to listen to everybody.
Oh, fuck
you're
all him. He made a bunch of... Did you contact him when he made a couple of stinker movies and said, what were you doing there?
No, he's still very pretty close to me and helps me out a lot.
All right, fair enough. Listen, Eric.
Bullshit.
Again, why does he hate you, though, Jimmy? I don't understand why Eric hates you.
Well, I don't know. Eric, why do you hate me?
Because you severely made fun of me that morning after I appeared at your studio.
How does that make me different from every other person you meet?
He hates them, too.
Eric, they make fun of everybody on the show. I mean, that's the deal when you sign on.
You got to know the rules, man.
Kimmel is actually not really a part of that show, technically.
Oh. That's a good point. He makes a point.
He makes a real good point. All right, Eric, thank you. That is Eric the Midget. Everyone thrilled to be speaking to him. And Jimmy, I see you're captivated by him.
I am. I love him. I swear to God. It really breaks my heart that he doesn't like me. But what are you going to do?
Jimmy, everyone is curious about your relationship. Easy. Eric, what is it? Eric the Midget needs to say something. Yes, Eric. And I only... Yes.
I was calling in because I didn't get to talk about the shows that I'm going to be doing tonight and tomorrow night.
Eric, you had your shot on. You're on with all the celebrities.
You're
calling for plugs? Well, I was mainly calling today for that. I didn't expect to get thrown into the celebrity thing.
I see. Well, wow. I don't think Eric should be limited to the amount of calls, right?
No, I don't think there should be any limit to Eric. I think there should be like a Howard 102, and it should all be all Eric, the Midget.
Yeah, but he's interrupting a commercial with a commercial of his own.
I don't think that's legal. That is weird.
What's great about Eric is that it's always a reveal. He talks so slowly, you really never know what's coming, so there's the opportunity for something brilliant that's going to come out. That's what keeps me listening to Eric.
Yeah, we're still waiting for something brilliant.
But you do wait.
It's hard to decide also if Eric has the world's smallest head or the world's biggest hat on right now.
I don't think any hat fits his head. All right, I tell you what, Eric, I'll put you back on hold, and then when I get done with this, I will find out what your plug is, all right?
Okay, no problem. Hey,
can I interrupt your commercial as well?
Yeah. All right, let's go back to Eric the Midget, who really did want to say something.
Oh, him again?
Well, all right, he's been holding on. Oh. Yeah.
All right, Eric, go ahead quickly.
I was going to talk about my shows that I have tonight and tomorrow night.
Well, that's very exciting.
Take care, Eric.
Eric, do you ever consider that your timing is horrible? That like we're having this fun conversation, and then all of a sudden you get on and all you want to do is plug?
Well, I told the people in the room since I was in my chat room listening to let me know when the contest was over. They let me know a bit too early, obviously.
Mm-hmm. All right, quickly, what do you want to plug?
If fun were a car, you'd be a speed bump. You understand?
Do you guys ever listen to Eric's broadcasts?
Yes, not only that, I really had to like watch myself because I started to get obsessed with it. I started watching it online. And I realized I was headed in a dangerous path and that I could become, really, just spend my whole life watching Eric.
You were one of the online guys.
Yeah.
You went to his JFSC.
When I figured it out, I was like, oh, no, I better not do this. I better not do this.
Are you a JFSC member?
I think so, yeah. I think I had to sign up, whatever, right, to watch.
Do you know, Eric has a country show now. I don't know if you heard the show the other day where he has a country music show.
Did
you
I like that. Show? I did not, no.
All right, well, I'll play some of it real quick because I want to get to news real quick today because I have a big meeting. Very
really?
Busy man. No, not
what
really.
Is,
but
well, yeah. What's the mogul doing today?
Yeah.
Eric, are you an Oakland A's fan?
Yeah, and San Francisco Giants.
Yeah, we found out he's both, which is bullshit. But
yeah.
How is that possible?
Can't be.
Right, here's Eric from his country show. You ready? Evidently, Eric can't hear his own show while he's doing it.
Have you heard this? This is the greatest show that has ever gone on.
Yeah.
All right, here we go. This is a random
JD
clip.
Preview page.
I got
to
it.
Get in orange. It's in brown.
Like Christopherson would do.
Oh, sounds awful.
Get if he was your engineer, he would be freaking out.
But after that long pause, there's always this click, like this thud that he comes. He's like,
click,
click, and then he starts talking in the music
over the vocals.
Oh, yeah, but he misses the pause completely.
All right, here you go. You ready?
Can I show you? This is the mic right here.
All right, hold on. Here it is. Here it is. Horrible show, Jerry.
I think he just has to polish up his transitions. He might have something.
Jimmy, you were a professional disc jockey. I mean, what do you think?
Yeah, Eric, what's going on? You know, you talk over the fade of the song that, as the song's fading, you talk over that, and then when there are the vocals, you don't talk at the same time as the vocals.
Right. This is the mic that I use with the green button.
We can't see anything.
I've got a beer in my left hand. The other's my wedding band. That awful country music.
Eric, are you nervous about being in the movie?
No, not really.
No, he doesn't really get nervous.
All right, good.
I don't think Eric's going to come through. I think he's going to find a way to kind of weasel out of the movie.
I'm afraid so.
Oh, I hope Colin is writing for Eric because I don't expect much acting. I think the part has to be perfect.
Yesterday,
I also like the idea that Eric's mad at me after I got him tickets to the American Idol finale, the plane, all that stuff, and he screwed me and decided not to come. He's mad at me because I made fun of him.
But you shouldn't be mad at him.
But that's the best way to get on Eric's bad side. Do something for him.
Oh, yeah, you're right.
He hates me, and all I do is nice things for him. I got him Catherine McPhee's home phone number. which she still thanks me
nice for. Nice for her, too. Yeah.
It was good for her. It was good for him.
Eric?
Yes, I'm here.
And what about the balloons? I mean, I don't want to beat a dead horse here, but is this ever going to happen, the flying with balloons?
Oh, he's never going to do it.
Everywhere I go, people are like, oh, you got to get Eric on the balloon.
He's afraid we're going to open the window and let him go sailing out the window.
I told him about that priest who flew away in Brazil.
Yeah. No, we'll make sure that doesn't happen. We'll be standing by with BB guns.
We'll shoot you down if anything happens.
I love it.
Jimmy's going to bring a BB gun.
Yeah.
You want to be here when he flies with balloons.
Are you kidding me? I want to be the one that cuts the string, and I want to see him float away with balloons. Eric?
That's not ever going to happen.
All right. All right, Eric, I got to go, really.
Tonight on the JFSC, there's...
Bye!
First to the final
We'll see you later, Eric. Thanks for calling him.
And...
Take care of yourself. You got any? All right, see you later.
Shut up, fat ass. You obnoxious fat ass.
Oh, come on. We know where to find you, dude. You don't move. Just, you know.
Hey, is that an enormous pimple on your forehead?
No, it's not.
It's his brother.
Julio. That's his face.
Pull your hat up. I'm telling you.
Just pull the hat down farther.
Pull it up.
No.
No.
His whole face is red today. What's going on?
Why are you so red-faced?
I don't know.
You have big pimples and look at your cheek even.
Yeah.
I'm a Kennedy.
Your skin doesn't look good today.
What are you doing? Did you try some new product?
No, I have not tried a new product.
All right. Listen, I got to go, okay? I got a lot to do.
Okay.
All right, thank you. Speak to you later. Bye for now.
Break a leg. That's what actors say.
And you should listen to Jerry about taking him up on some acting lessons.
Yeah.
If you're smart. Guy's been around the block, knows what he's doing. All right, thank you.
Now, Eric.
Eric, were you pleased with the outcome of American Idol?
Yeah, I was. Glad that David Cook won.
Yeah, I was too, actually.
Why?
Because I liked him better. The other
better
kid.
Better Cinderella story?
Yeah, I think so. Bartender becomes the American Idol. I don't know. I liked it.
After what you said, though, I feel bad for him. Is his father going to go nuts on that Archuleta?
Yeah, the other kid's really in trouble with their dad. I understand the dad. You should have sang what I told you to do.
Well, he beat him by 12 million votes.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's a definite win.
Let's see. Eric's show from last night. What page is that on, boys? Let's take a quick...
JD1.
Yeah, I was listening to the playback of the show yesterday, and Eric was on a really long time, and I realized what the listeners mean. We can only leave Eric on a short time.
Is that right?
Yeah.
Shut the fuck up, listeners.
Oh.
Now, there are times where it goes on too long. They're right. They're right.
It's not just the listeners, Eric. We feel the same exact way.
Shut up, fat ass. I'm in the mood.
You're not in the mood?
Wow.
Then don't call in. How dare you?
I mean, I'm not in the mood to deal with your dumb ass.
Well, I'm here, dude. I have to say something.
Go ahead, JD.
The better ones are in orange. And then the regular American Idol clips are in the third column.
Okay, got it. So what would you... Let's see. Let me just read with these to you. You can tell me. Carrie Underwood and Kimmel, it says.
Yeah. It's just them talking. Huh? It's just stupid.
Jimmy Kimmel was on. It's funny.
He was on American Idol?
I was emailing Jimmy Kimmel, like, maybe not less than a half hour before he went on American Idol. He didn't mention once that he was going on American Idol.
Hey, Howard.
Yeah.
John DeHaan says that it was very obvious that that was pre-taped, including Ryan's reactions, that Jimmy wasn't there live.
Oh,
I figured as much, because Jimmy didn't say a word to me about it. I mean, it would be weird to be emailing someone and go, shit, I got to go on American Idol in a fucking half hour. I go, he's incredibly relaxed. I mean, that's millions of people watching you.
I think they taped their shows at the same time.
Did you think Jimmy Kimmel was good, Eric, or did you give him a negative reaction?
I didn't laugh once at what he said.
See, I thought he was pretty good.
See, he doesn't like Jimmy anymore.
Right. Are you just saying that because you don't like him, or you really felt he wasn't funny?
Both.
All right.
When's the last time you laughed at something, Eric?
I watch a lot of sitcoms. I laugh at those.
What's your favorite? We're all jumping to that.
Everybody Hates Chris and also Two and a Half Men.
Wow.
Fascinating.
His fingers on the pulse.
He likes the half man part.
Two and a half man, you think he relates to the half man?
He relates to the half man.
He could be in that show.
Yeah, you know, it's funny, quietly, Chris Rock, man, he might go into that, like, $100 million range, because that show's been on a few yeah. years.
It's on the CW, though.
Yeah, but if it's syndication, he's got to own a huge chunk of that, man.
Yeah, Chris told me
he's got about 2 years till syndication, or September it will hit season four.
Chris told me that this was his shot at making money, that, believe it or not, he said to me, he's well-known as I am, because I don't have a lot of dough.
Well, I think he's hanging out with Eddie Murphy, you know.
Yeah, he says, I don't have the big money. He says, this is my shot with this fucking sitcom.
Really? I thought, it depends on what's big money. Like, before this sitcom, I would think you'd be worth $20 million.
That's what you'd think, but I get the feeling maybe not.
Do you think that's what he means by not huge money, having 20
No, I think
mil?
He means a lot less than 20 mil. I think
really?
20 mil would be a lot of money, don't you?
I'm just saying he's been in show business, making movies, doing a bunch of things for a long time. But you know what? You're right.
That's his lifestyle.
Yeah, he's got...
Wife, every time I see her, she's got a different designer outfit.
He's done a ton of commercials.
Right.
But, that one time he was in here saying, like, when the wife hangs out with Eddie Murphy's wife, when Eddie Murphy was married, she comes back like, how come we don't have a jet? Oh, that's because I wasn't in Beverly Hills Cop 1, 2, 3.
Funny. What is the best Eric clip to play so I don't drag this out? I got Eric annoyed with question. Eric, Carrie Underwood. Eric, you must have had a little boner going when Carrie Underwood was on.
That was a very nice outfit.
Yes. Would you sign her to your modeling agency?
Oh, yeah. Definitely.
Yeah, but
God, if only she wanted to do it.
And then he locked her in his house because she has to. Part of the contract is she has to live with Eric, or in a house nearby.
She has to have Eric chained to her ankle.
You sign anyone yet to your modeling agency?
No.
What the?
What? You mean people aren't flocking?
Is the chloroform not working?
You mean no girl wants to live in your house or very close by? Within a mile radius?
No, not yet.
Yeah, it's a shame.
There's a tour yet.
Eric Midget Show watching Carrie Underwood. Oh, I bet she was carrying on about her. Let's hear that.
Is that who I think it is, Eric?
Yes, it is.
Eric's smoking fine.
Okay, I thought she looked hot. Looks Monday night. Nice.
And you can see just right up her fucking skirt when they hit the right angle with the camera. That's tight.
Not only that, it does not appear like there's anything under that blazer.
I don't think there is.
Eric with the keen eye. No panties, right, Eric?
Yep, damn. She's wearing panties.
Oh, she is. Your co-host.
It was weird. It's like he just answered you right here.
Yeah, she's singing like mad, Eric. Singing well, looking good.
She's singing to Eric.
Hey, Eric, that guy who's on the show, he's stepping all over you. He's not giving you a minute to talk.
Well, there was a problem where we were experiencing a lag problem.
But we want to hear you suck, not him suck.
Yeah, we can hear him suck anywhere.
Yeah.
There's a lag problem.
Yeah, there's a lag problem.
The system that we use, there was a problem where it was lagging on my end.
All right, sounds like there's a fag problem, you and that show.
You want to hear Eric Wally?
Yeah, there is with you and
you know what's weird? Eric kicks people out of the room while he's on the show.
Oh, that's my favorite.
All right, let's play that clip. So while Eric's doing his radio show, he is kicking people out of his chat room.
Yeah, when people write him things, he just kicks them out.
You know where you're going?
To the moon.
Same place the other one went.
So are they going to get to the friggin' Who's the Idol or what? Jesus.
I don't know, but because of what Joey Boots just said,
you're kicking Joey
he's
Boots
gonna
out.
Go bye bye. Mm-hmm.
Look what it said, Ack-Ack. I don't care who it is. No, that's the right thing to say if you want to stay in here.
Oh, bye, Boots. Ack-Ack.
Come on.
You have no sense of humor.
You don't like that Ack-Ack noise, Eric?
No, it's retarded.
All right. Are you wearing lipstick?
Yeah,
oh, a little glossy.
What are you wearing on your lips?
Nothing.
Oh, yeah, bullshit.
That does look like lipstick.
I'm not wearing a damn thing, you blind-ass bastard.
Did you blow a clown?
Oh. No.
You didn't blow a clown.
Did you blow an American Indian?
I don't understand. Why would an American Indian give you red lips?
Red skin.
Oh, okay, all right, all right. I'm with you. Sometimes I need some help.
Heck, you're a dumbass.
Who?
Are you trying to get a lipstick endorsement? Your lips are bright red.
This is Eric the Midget. Maybelline.
I'm worrying about you. You're shaving your eyebrows and making your lips red.
And you have a show called Eric's Idol Review.
I'd wear lipstick if I had a show like that.
Absolutely.
What are you? Did you put on lip gloss?
Did you put on, like, some kind of gloss?
No.
You're
I
lying.
I put it on for Cam.
Cam. Chapstick.
Yeah.
Chapstick, maybe. There's something on there.
There's not a damn thing on there except for skin.
Oh.
Wow, you...
But what have you been doing?
I have naturally kissable lips.
You have very lush lips. I've never noticed.
Dude, just go the whole way and turn your cock into a pussy. Come on.
That is what you want to do, isn't it?
No, I mean, I'd like for you to do it, yeah.
Joey Boots wrote Ack-Ack and you kicked him out?
That's where you're going, Boots.
So how many people did you kick out of your chat room last night?
Lost count.
They said he's kicked over 4,000 people.
Since really? Does anybody started. Stay in this chat room?
No.
You kicked out over 4,000 people?
That must be some kind of record.
Mm. Well, if he's kicking people out just for saying Ack-Ack.
That's a baby.
Joey Boots.
What is this, school?
Plus, who knows if that's the real Joey.
I'm just going to kick smallest out. Feel free to do the honors then. Well, Eric, you're up to over 4,000 kicks since we started.
4,000 kicks? Eric, it must be a nice position for you to be able to kick people out of the chat room in a sense. You know, your whole life, you haven't had that kind of power and... You know, with your handicap and stuff, it's hard for you to physically dominate certain people. But now, in a sense, in the chat room, you are, you know, the cyber Iron Man, so to speak.
He's the pretty girl. He gets to choose.
You get to choose who gets to stay and who gets to leave. It must be wonderful, right?
Yeah.
You admit that you love it.
You like playing God. In the chat room, you're God. You realize that? Yeah, sure. What?
Maybe.
In the chat room, you're tall, handsome.
I think of myself as little Hitler.
And a tyrant.
You're like Mr. Spacely, and they're like George Jetson.
You'll be happy to know that Carrie Underwood is calling in right now.
Oh, no.
Hi, Carrie.
Hi, how are you?
Very nice to speak to you. You look beautiful last night.
You have a come-hither voice. Mm.
Oh, well, thank you very much.
Is there anyone?
Hi, Eric.
I was going to say, is there anyone in particular you want to speak to, Carrie?
Yes, I just heard Eric calling in. I wanted to say hello to him. How are you, Eric?
And you wonder why yesterday's segment went so long, because you wasted time with dumbass calls like this.
It's not a dumbass call.
That's Carrie Underwood.
Why wouldn't we take her call?
You think this is dumb?
It's fat fuck high pitch.
Who's high pitch? This is Carrie Underwood. And I'm not a fat fuck. I'm a beautiful girl.
Well, Carrie, obviously he doesn't believe it's you, so I'm going to hang up.
Oh, well, fuck him.
All right.
Bye, Eric.
Bye.
So Something about Carrie Underwood's voice sounds like she's been sleeping in her own feces.
No, that's not true.
Yeah. All right. Thank you, Carrie. I'm sure you have to get to rehearsal.
Yes, I do. You guys have a great day, and I'll talk to you soon.
Yeah, I'm sure you have sound check. All right, thank
you. Yes, I do.
Right. I'm sure you have to get a forklift and empty the litter box in your apartment.
No, not true. I have to fly with balloons of air.
I'm sure you have to, you know, eat 4,000 pounds of food before going to work.
And then shit it out at the community bathroom.
No, because I'm a beautiful skinny girl.
Could you imagine if you live on the floor where you share it with him and you're waiting to get in there and he's in there shitting up a storm.
All right, thank you, Carrie.
That's when you take a cab to the Verrazano Narrows Bridge, get out, and jump off.
All right, let's go to Alec, who wants to say good morning to us. Alec, you're on the air in Plymouth, Mass. Go ahead.
Hey, Eric.
Yes?
Hey, are you wearing a dress and high heels with that lipstick?
Are you a retarded brainless fuckhead? Off the phone, asswipe.
Well, hey, we have two questions on the board.
I was going to say yesterday, when Carrie Underwood was calling you, I'd say, have you ever been diagnosed with Down syndrome? You're retarded.
You think Eric's retarded?
You are, aren't you?
Eric's, no, really. Like,
I can't figure out Eric's level of intelligence, because Eric seems pretty intelligent to me, and then all of a sudden, like, he falls for the Carrie Underwood thing.
I know.
I think Gary the retard's less gullible than Eric Mitch. I really do.
No, I was listening back to yesterday's show.
Where that shoo-shoo retarded flu shit wasn't gullible.
Oh, my God.
We're saying, yeah.
When did retard rub their pussy on the phone, too? Remember that?
Yeah.
That was great.
You were rubbing your dick on the phone just like Wendy, you fag.
I didn't rub any private part on the phone, fuck wad.
You're retarded.
No, I'm not, jackass.
Just a minute.
On the phone.
You fight like Gary the retard.
I know, man. All right, thanks, guys.
All right, later.
Gary's always going, shut up, Angel.
Eric hates everyone.
I guess he would have gotten kicked out of the room for saying stuff.
Yeah, he would have been kicked out, huh, Eric?
Yes.
He would be going bye-bye.
All right. Hey, Eric, I got to go. Congratulations.
What are you congratulating him
on? On the another fine season of his radio show.
Wow.
What do you mean?
He's got more. He's got like five other shows he's going to watch.
Well, yeah, he's watching every reality show for the summer, including Last Comic Standing.
and what is he doing?
A show.
Oh, he'll do the show during the show?
Yeah.
All right.
Wait, you didn't play the clip where I was complaining about a question. Play that one.
Bye.
Now, Eric, we've had enough.
See you later.
Play that clip.
Why did he need to play that clip?
Take care, Eric.
I pulled the clip. You don't have to play it.
No, don't play it.
Why does he need to play it?
Don't.
Why do I need to play that clip?
Don't play it.
Wait, I gotta hear this. Why do I need to play the clip?
Just play the clip now.
Jesus.
What?
No.
Who the fuck are you to tell me what clip to play?
Eric, we'll see you later.
What? Are you crazy?
Yes.
Why do you want me to play the clip?
Just play the damn clip.
And what about if he doesn't?
Because it has something to do with Taxi Driver. That's what the question is about.
Yeah, but we don't care. It's enough. That's your show. I played a little bit. I want to give the ambiance of your show. I can't replay your whole show.
It actually has nothing to do with Taxi Driver.
Right.
He's lying.
That's what the question was about, JD.
No, it wasn't.
I gotta go.
I have a show, Eric.
You and JD worked this out.
Yeah, you guys worked it out.
No, we're not working on nothing.
All right. Thanks, Eric.
I told the room I'm not doing Taxi Driver.
Take care, Eric.
Good. All right. Good. All right. No Taxi Driver.
Like
good.
Usual.
Nobody gives a shit. Why are you not doing Taxi Driver?
Oh, you got sucked in.
I did. Why are you not doing Taxi Driver?
Because I'm sick of being asked by your retarded fans that, obviously, unlike what you think, they don't listen to your show because they keep asking me if I'm going to do the damn movie, and I keep having to tell them yes.
See, this is when I think you're retarded.
You're crazy.
He hates getting asked questions over and over. Like
He thinks everybody sees his answer to every question all the time, and everyone's following his every
exactly.
word.
Exactly.
Right.
And, Eric, if they don't listen to the show, how do they know you were going to do Taxi Driver?
Right.
Right.
Eric, you're being retarded. You really are.
No, I'm not.
Yeah, you kind of are, but it's fine. Don't do taxi driver.
That's
We're done.
Retarded response.
Yeah. I don't like that people keep asking me the same question. What do you
no,
think?
No, I'm not doing it.
See, everybody knows you and everything you are going to do every minute. See, everybody hears every minute of my show and knows the answers to everything you say.
Well, you seem to think that everybody's holding on everyone.
Well, no, they're not. No. Unfortunately, I don't think that.
You think it.
Yeah. All right, I got to go. I'm sorry you're not doing taxi driver. That's a shame.
And we're not playing the clip.
Right, goodbye.
Hey, wait a minute.
No.
You know, he loves extending his own airtime.
See, this is ridiculous.
This is why these segments, because he always tries to drag it out, and that's why people hate the segments. They get too long.
They get too long.
Oh. Gets verbose.
I don't want to be rude. I'm sorry. Didn't you say, wait a minute?
Wait a minute.
Call that.
Mm.
Oh, you guys are off next week, right?
Yeah.
Maybe.
We don't know for sure, though. We might show up.
I was hoping to do a show for you guys.
We'll see you later, Eric.
All right, bye.
Off.
Take care, buddy.
You want to do... Eric, you're horrible on the radio. There's no way you could carry a radio show.
Not only are you horrible, you're not going to do our movie. Why should we do something for you?
You got a little boring after, like, 3 seconds on the air.
Answer all those questions.
That's where you talk.
Yeah.
He's on a delay, though. I like when he insults us, and then you see him insult us again.
And then the lips move.
Yeah.
I love that.
Eric, it's not going to happen. You're not doing a fill-in show for us. Can you imagine a four-hour Eric
show? I would probably hang in for the whole 4 hours. But!
You'd have to be chained to a chair.
You'd be one of the few.
I don't want you to do it.
Eric, I can't see that happening. Sorry.
Why not?
Well, number one, you're not dependable. Number two...
Yeah, if people ask you about it, then you'll quit.
Number two, I hear your radio show over the internet. It's very disjointed. If you get naked right now and fuck your pillow, I'll give you a show.
Pillow or a bed, you know.
Yeah, show us how you fuck your bed.
Do a threesome with your two pillows and the bed.
Fuck no, I'm not doing that.
Oh, there you go, you see. You don't want it that bad.
No fuck, no show.
Right. You're not hungry enough.
No fucky, no showy.
Now, Eric, you know what? Seriously, I can't do that. But thank you, and thank you for the offer. And I'm sorry you're not doing the movie, but I do have to move along. I've got a huge show to get to today. We have Cyndi Lauper coming in to perform. We have the hottest chick, ugliest scar. Everyone's looking forward to that. And I have a lot of tape and things to get to, okay? And I want you to have a nice weekend.
You know that I've not heard from Johnny for a couple of days.
Okay.
What was he busy doing? Anything else?
I know why you guys want to hear.
Sure, okay. Go ahead.
Wow, he's throwing everyone under the bus just to stay on the air.
Why haven't you heard from Johnny in a few days?
Because he's going to end up having another baby.
Well, why would he can't talk to you?
I guess for some reason it's making him too busy to take my call. I don't know why.
Oh, maybe he just got sick of you like most other people do.
Yeah. He has a life.
Yeah, I mean, he got one other activity.
You were knocked off of his priorities. Well, I'm
listen,
sorry.
Eric, I can't call you back. I'm too busy breathing.
Have a heart attack already.
Didn't, you know what? Now that's a mean thing to say.
That's a terrible thing.
Didn't Johnny tell us he was pregnant again with him and his girl?
No, I haven't heard that.
I thought he told us that a couple months ago.
Oh, no, I didn't hear that.
He can't stand having kids. Why is he having so many kids?
Really?
He hates that.
This little fucker, she's fucking pregnant.
Yeah. All right, I got to go, Eric. Thank you, and God bless. Thank you very much. Bye-bye.
All right.
Bye for now.
Bye, shithead.
Shithead and fat fuck.
Yeah, I mean, I like that.
I love it.
I'd listen to that.
That's a good team.
I could listen. If you were willing to come in and do his show, I would listen to you and Eric. Sure.
Well, you know what? I'd be honored. I'd do that.
Sure.
Shithead and fat fuck. Weren't those two bombs they dropped on Japan?
They nicknamed them that.
Those are the names of the two cities.
JD, so where was the American Idol course?
The regular American Idol is in the third column. On JD.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
As opposed to the Eric show.
Yes.
All right, here is a... Oh, David Cook got to play with ZZ Top.
Yeah,
that was another thing.
That.
Wow.
They're all coming
and
out.
It was great because ZZ Top is great.
Look at this.
He's still on?
He's still there.
Yeah, Artie, you better get ready for that ride, ride on the Sibian, because who knows, Bruce Springsteen may be on next year.
Yeah, well, I don't think that's happening. He's got too much money and hopefully too much pride.
Guys from New Jersey, ladies and gentlemen, raise your hands. It's Bruce Springsteen.
God, it would have hurt to see him do this.
You can see it happening.
Look, the day we split out on the streets of
Archuleta to join Bruce.
Didn't we ride through mansions? Now there's a fat kid in the audience with a gun. What's happening?
Machine. That's David Archuleta singing with him.
Spun from cages on
the suicide machine.
Home wheel fuel injected and stepping out over the line. Baby, this town rips the bones from your back. It's a death. The suicide rap.
Oh, God.
You know why Springsteen is going to appear on the show?
Tell me why.
Somebody told me not too long ago he's complaining that his audience, there's no young people in it.
I got to tell you, if he wants to feel relevant, he could just sell out 15 nights at the Garden and he'll go have fun.
No, he'd like to see some young people there. He doesn't want to see you there anymore, Artie.
Really?
Yeah, he's sick of you. He wants young people.
I could put on some, you know, makeup or something.
I want to see 40-year-old comedians.
I don't know, ladies and gentlemen, I want to see 40-year-old comedians. I was obsessing last night on the fact that, you know, because I agree with you that people are going to start thinking I clearly have an insane amount of problems, because almost all my buddies from high school, and I'm still close with 20 guys, they're all pretty much married. Or were married.
Yeah, I knew you were bummed out, but you can't have kids until you straighten out your whole situation.
Yeah.
Well, nobody said he was going to go out and just have kids.
No, that's what he'll do if you see him encouraging this.
Oh.
He's going to go bang some broads.
I wasn't encouraging that,
I'm afraid I can't with all the shit I put in my mouth.
Nah, you're fine.
Oh, oh please. You could have 50 babies. They'll all be a little...
What?
A little retarded, but... You'll be fine in that department.
When me and Sal were arguing, he...
You know how many heroin addicts have kids?
Well, me and Sal were arguing that the one of the most vicious things he said was that your kids, from all the heroin in your blood, your kids will have Down syndrome.
Oh.
Woo! The gloves were off.
All right, thank you, Eric. I'm sorry. I have to leave you. Yes. All right. Takes forever to say goodbye. Idol show last night because American Idol was on. And
yeah.
It's just so great. Eric did make an admission on the show. Finally, something came out of the show that his roommate catches him beating off.
Ooh.
Or has caught him.
How did that come up?
Well, first of all, you almost miss it. You got to listen like a surgeon would operate on a person. Like you got to be so lasered into what's going on.
Yeah, you got to look for all the bleeders.
Here's the opening to Eric's show. And I'm not editing this in any way, but this is exactly what it sounds like. This is it. And it's just amazing to me.
What the hell are you?
Eric's got his TV way up too loud, you know, because he's watching American Idol during it. That's what you're hearing.
Oh, I'm doing okay, Eric. There he is. Hey, King.
25.
I'm late like Artie. I had flu-like symptoms.
Jackson's career journey. We're in Jacksonville, Florida tonight. I thought it was supposed to be Miami.
Eric's big revelation there is that the American Idol judging is going on in Jacksonville, Florida. But if I'm watching the show, wouldn't I know that?
He's shocked because he thought it was Miami.
Yeah. And he's supposed to be an expert.
Where are they again, Eric? I'm sorry.
Jacksonville, Florida.
Jacksonville.
Ah, okay.
I thought tonight was supposed to be Miami, Florida. Oh, my goodness.
You get it?
There was a scrawny guy.
That's the show. So
and
somehow,
you didn't cut this up. That's
no.
just how it played on the computer.
Yeah. And then I guess if you listen long enough, like this is like almost an hour in or something, you know. This is Eric confessing that his roommate has caught him beating off. So at least there was some sort of revelation. So listen carefully, see if you can catch it.
Hey, Eric, have you ever caught Jan jerking off?
No, and don't care to.
That's the guy who lives with Eric, you know.
Jan,
I guess.
You never accidentally rolled in on him doing something bad to himself?
Nope.
Has he ever walked in on you rubbing one out?
Oh, my goodness.
It's something that roommates do have to deal with sometimes.
Hey. Maybe he has.
Ooh, God. Thank you, Eric. I appreciate your candor. I'm not even going to ask you to elaborate.
Wow. Thank you.
It's almost like CB radio.
I mean, worse. Like, why wouldn't you ask him to elaborate?
They're finally onto something good.
Yeah, you want to stick with this American Idol conversation?
Yeah, well, the show really is about American Idol, Rob, not about Eric's masturbation. Well, anyway, I hand it to JD because he listens to the show every night and pulls these little gems. And I would have missed that. I mean...
Yeah, you'd have been asleep by the time that came up.
It's incredibly dull. Too much, huh? Well, that's the Eric the Idol show, or Idol Watcher show.
When are they going to give up on this show?
Never.
That's what I wonder. Because it hasn't worked once.
Eric was on the phone yesterday all morning trying to promote it. And I didn't let him on yesterday. We were just in the middle of 20 different things. Yesterday's show just went really fast. What is it, JD?
You know, he doesn't just have the American Idol show. He has he has an ECW show and a TNA wrestling show
and
Nashville Star show and all these other shows.
With the same co-host?
No, I think there's this guy named Cole that he does ECW with.
And it's always while a show is on, right?
Yeah, I guess. I haven't listened to the other shows. I can barely handle this one.
Maybe the show would be better if they didn't do it while Eric was watching the show. Like, it's got to ruin his experience of watching American Idol.
Well, I pulled a clip. It's too boring anyway, but...
No, it isn't.
The co-hosts yell at him because apparently he talks way more off-air than he does on-air.
I see.
So they yell at him for talking...
Who's he talking to off-air?
Yeah. I think it's the very last one.
All right.
You guys got any questions you want to ask Eric before the end of the show?
Eric, do you have anything to say? Not really.
That's the craziest show. Do you have anything to say, Eric?
All right, guys.
This is what I don't understand. You call in the Stern every day like it's the most important fucking thing in the whole universe. And then when you come on this show, it's like pulling teeth trying to get a straight answer out of you.
Because he's watching American Idol and he loves it.
What? Yeah, this is a bad premise for a show.
Yeah, like you know sports shows, like a Mad Dog watches a game, right. And then he comes on and he talks about it.
He doesn't talk to you during the game.
He's not a play-by-play announcer. He's an analyst. He does analysis of it after the fact.
Yeah, like our guy, Pharrell.
Right, exactly, Pharrell, yeah.
He reads like 97 sports papers, and then he comes on the air and he talks about it.
And he watches games. So what you're saying is Eric should watch the show and then have an after-Idol show.
Yes, after-Idol show. That's what I'm advocating, where he could actually talk. He's too busy watching the show. He loves that show. It's like during the Super Bowl, having some guy talk during it. Why would you do that? Unless it was actually the broadcast of the Super Bowl. Makes no sense. JD played this for me. I think this is great. This was JD actually got it off of YouTube somehow. I don't know how he got it. But I guess Eric the Midget was doing his American Idol show last night.
Okay.
And we haven't listened to that in a while. And I just love this show. This is one of my favorite shows, Eric the Midget's American Idol show. And what happens to Eric the Midget in this particular segment, he actually quits his own show. I think he walked off. And what happens is during his show, he also has people texting. You know, they have some sort of chat room going on.
Right.
And Eric sits and reads the chat. instead of playing to his radio audience,
he's talking to the people who are writing.
So some guy, of course, inevitably busts his balls. And somehow this guy who was busting his balls was made a moderator in the chat room, which drove Eric to distraction. He got off his game. And then it's like a guy at a comedy club who gets heckled and then he only talks to the heckler.
Yeah.
Eric the Midget is engaged in yelling at a guy. The guy's riding. You don't know what the guy's riding. But in the middle of the radio show, Eric has a meltdown and starts yelling at the moderator. So here he is. You got to get into Eric's rhythm. You know how that goes. But here is Eric from his award-winning radio show, American Idol show.
All right.
And you can hear American Idol being played in the background because Eric is watching it.
No, I don't really have any big plans for my birthday, really. Hang on, guys. On my TT now. Especially with that shitty name. Take him off the fucking mod list. I fucking highly doubt that Johnny asked for him to be modded.
This is some show, isn't this great? He's yelling.
What am I listening to?
You're listening to Eric screaming at the people who run his chat room to take that guy off being moderator. The mod list.
Off the mod list now. Or the show is fucking over.
Now he's threatening to take...
He'll walk off his own show.
He's walking off his own show. It's this guy, one stupid guy. He just ignore him. Don't look at the chat room.
Yeah, right, you fucking talk to Johnny, you piece of shit idiot.
You have no idea what he's talking about. He doesn't explain to anyone. He's engaged in a fight with
him. At least read us what he's writing so we know what you're yelling about.
Sounds like somebody, like this guy's claiming he talked to Johnny Frotto.
Right.
Okay.
Take that fucking retard off the mod list. Jan's calling Johnny. I'm not going to do it in the middle of this.
So now Jan is calling Johnny to take care of this moderator. From what I can tell, this is what's going on at this point. Somehow I follow this.
Take that mod ship. Take that mod ship away. Now. Dirty raw retard. I am not Jewish. I am Irish, you retarded fuck. I'm not yelling as if it's retard or it's bad to be Jewish.
You love when people are yelling and they go, I'm not yelling.
But he's not watching the show. He's supposed to be...
He's engaged in a
commenting
war.
On the Idol show.
And I guess somebody called him Jewish.
Yes.
Yeah, now he's getting upset.
Now he's
got to
correct that.
Yeah. Now, you've been in radio a long time. This isn't good radio. You tell Eric.
This is like a bad phone call.
I'm just yelling at the fucker because he's calling me something that I'm obviously not. Do I look at all Jewish? Not that it's bad.
I look kind of Jewish. It's not
but
that
But wait
great.
A minute.
Yeah.
What does Eric look like? I mean, would you... Is that an
does
Irish
Does he look Irish? Yeah, I guess he looks Irish.
Oh, please. Well, he maybe looks like a leprechaun.
He looks midget-ish.
T.T., stop with the bullshit, you idiot.
Now other people are jumping in because they're getting a reaction from Eric. Big pauses.
No, because he's not getting an apology for shit for his retarded ass comment that got him kicked out of here the last time.
Anyway, that's Eric's radio show.
Wow.
There's a little piece of that. I know you can't handle it, but I love it. I love that radio show. It's a train wreck and I like it.
He's breaking all the rules.
So the ratings came out yesterday. As predicted, we didn't beat Dancing with the Stars. We were second place.
Mm-hmm.
Which, you know, I would love to. I wish they would have waited 2 weeks. You know, Dancing with the Stars
when
in their
you
finale.
Your own world.
So in 2 weeks, we'll be then some of the papers were like, they got it. We came in number one, 18 to 49 right. year olds. So the network called me. They were thrilled because from the network standpoint, they were like, they had nothing to go up against Dancing with the Stars with. So they were left. Because some of the papers are saying, well, Howard Stern didn't beat Dancing with the Stars, right. so he didn't bring anything to it. Last year, Dancing with the Stars debuted against nothing. Their leading
you
was
mean
the voice.
America's Got Talent?
I mean, yeah. America's Got Talent went on last year and didn't have to go up against anything, really, mm-hmm. which I would have preferred because we're going up against their finale.
Right.
You know, and like I said to you, what I predict will happen is this show will grow every week. We had over 10 million viewers. And then we'll be the number one show by the summer, just like always. I think the show is that good.
Mm-hmm.
And NBC described to me on the phone. I said, why'd you guys program it against that? You know, we could have just been the number one show. And they go, well, hey, we needed something to put on. You guys did your mission. Your ratings were as high as The Voice. The Voice's finale.
Right.
You did phenomenally wow. well. And, you know, and that's what we needed. What were we going to put on? So... I would have liked to have been number one overall.
Sure.
I don't like just being number one 18 to 49, but, you know. So it was considered a success. And I was like, oh, shoo. It was like, oh, good. Because I didn't want to go on there and bomb.
Of course not.
And then they blame me, you know. So, I mean, everyone would say, you know, Howard Stern's show now.
Right.
The Howard Stern show. No, it's America's Got Talent. But I don't know. Everyone was waiting, I don't know for what, but it felt really good. And people seem to generally like the show,
mm-hmm.
especially the people who used to watch the show who aren't fans of mine seem to like my addition to the show.
Absolutely, yeah.
From what I heard.
Yeah.
Yeah. Eric the Midget, you're on the air. Eric the actor. Eric the actor.
Well, Eric's a big fan of the show.
Eric, we were in San Francisco, but they didn't show Eric last night,
no?
I don't think.
No, because I think I saw where I would have been, but the cotton candy guy, his big belly, I think, blocked me out.
Yeah, I don't know why they didn't show Eric.
Cotton Candy's belly blocked Eric.
Yeah. But Eric was there in San Francisco.
Mm-hmm. A couple of questions regarding that, and also a little thing about one of the contestants. Two questions. One is, why did they cut Howie's extremely funny line that he delivered to the opera singer guy?
They cut a lot of funny lines. They cut a lot of funny lines of mine. They cut out a lot of funny lines of Howie.
Well, he's particularly you know. Interested in Howie's line.
Yeah. I don't know. You know, Howie sometimes gets lines cut, and so do I.
The line was a joke about the guy making everybody, because he talked about helping people take crafts. Howie said, well, I think you helped everybody in here take a shit.
Oh.
Well, you know, they couldn't air that, Eric.
Right. I think, you know.
They could have believed it.
No, it's network television.
It's the family. You know, a friend of mine has been watching it with his kids, like a lot of people
uh-huh.
do. And even, like, when the stripper took off his shirt and he had the ring around. You remember with the first episode, the ring, he had it tied to his nipple or something?
Uh-huh.
Like, they have to answer an hour's worth of questions to their kids just with that. Like,
right.
Why did that man take off his clothes kind
yeah.
of thing? And why, you know, the kids, so if Howie's line gets bleeped, you got to sit there and go, no, he was making a duty joke, but he called it shit, and, you know, and then you got to go through a whole explanation.
One time at the table, they answered you saying that you were an ass.
Yeah, asshole. Yeah, that's not considered so bad anymore. I don't edit the show. That's the other thing. If I edited the show, it would just all be me. Quite frankly, I think I'm, you know, fantastic.
And then the other thing was the beginning, one of the beginnings, Howie flew in on a jetpack.
That wasn't really him.
Well, I know.
That's what I was thinking. Okay,
right.
They used a stunt person, then cut
right.
him into it, obviously.
Right. So then what's the problem?
I was wondering, making sure that it wasn't him, that they really didn't have him do that.
You know what? I wasn't there, so I don't know.
I can guarantee you Howie didn't do that.
Yeah, I just saw Howie walking around with a helmet on, and I go, what's going on? And they go, you know what? You do your thing. I don't even want to. Because they don't tell me. I just, you know, I was like, why is Howie wearing a helmet?
But
I would have assumed it wasn't Howie. I mean, considering his fear of everything.
Right.
I can't. I mean, the guy's afraid to touch people. I can't imagine him coming in on a jetpack. But I don't know. I don't know for sure, Eric. I don't want to say.
Right. It's been a
the one thing I wanted to say about one of the contestants, the contortionist dancer.
Yeah.
The one thing about him, he's good. One thing, if he's still in competition, ask him if he's ever been diagnosed with Ehlers-Danlos, because a lot of contortionists.
What did he say? I'm lost.
There's some
zoning.
Disease he wants you to check out. What he's got.
Robin.
I haven't paid attention to the last two questions. I'm like kind of sitting here thinking about what, like, Andy Richter's coming in and like what I'm going to do next. What?
But you can't. What disease a contortionist has?
Because Eric has. Because Eric has his bones all twisted up and he's thinking maybe they have the same sort of.
Okay, so what?
He wants to know, but I know it's not interesting.
Eric.
I don't know the guy's medical history.
Send him 20 packs of gum and hang up.
Gary, shut the fuck up. And, oh, yeah, Gary, I did not manipulate my list.
Manipulate?
Right. Hey, Eric, I got to go just because I got a guest coming, but it's good talking to you. And thanks for being there in San Francisco. Got to go. Bye.
Okay, talk to you next week.
Talk to you next week. How great would it be if Howie... I could have convinced Eric that Howie really travels around the country by jetpack.
Yeah, that's how he gets to every gig.
I would have done that if he had more time. Eric the actor is with us in Sacramento.
You had nothing to wrap up last night. What did he do?
Hey, you know, there was no AGT last night, so Eric couldn't do his AGT SFSC show last night.
It's JFSC, and I only do it Wednesday nights.
Oh. Why wouldn't you do your show right after America's Got Talent airs when people are anxious to talk about it?
Because I want to wait till both episodes air.
I see. That's important, evidently.
So you're the last to rap. Everybody else is doing it on the night of the show.
Hey, yeah. Where is my... Hey, Gary, where is the Eric the Actor tapes of his last show, which was a hoot?
There is, and he'll be very excited, there's an Eric the Actor AGT page.
My God, Eric's last show was maybe the worst show ever in the history of Eric's career.
Shut the fuck up.
Eric, why can't we hear you at least?
Eric, you don't know how bad the show sounds? Do you even listen to your own show at all, played back?
Do I sit and criticize your show?
You can do that. Yes. People do that all day and night. But, Eric, you're the star of the show, and all I hear is that fucking girl you work with.
If we even hear her papers rattling is louder than you.
You can't tell me that you're not upset about that.
She had all the questions in a Ziploc bag, and that's the noise that you heard.
Yeah, but Eric, the noise was louder than you. How can that be? And she doesn't listen to the show while she's doing it?
Well, you mean she doesn't listen to our own show?
Yeah. I mean, I can hear the sound mix on my show. Do you guys wear headphones?
No.
Oh.
Her and I don't.
No. What? How do you hear each other?
Because we're right near each other.
Oh, you're in the same room. I see.
Yes.
I'm in the same room with Fred. We all wear headphones, right. So we can hear what's going on.
So you can hear the relationship of sounds.
Eric, your show would be 1,000 times better with just that improvement. And Eric, by the way, if the guy who's the greatest radio performer in history, the most successful, gives you advice on a radio show, be smart enough to take it. What?
There's nothing professional about this setup. There's no microphones or anything. They're just using whatever mic is on the camera.
Oh, is that right?
Yeah, there's nothing. There's nothing. There's
but don't
no
you
mic.
Admit if Eric wore headphones, he'd be able to hear that his show is in disarray?
the show's in... The audio is the
I mean,
least
Eric is the... It's the Eric the Actor show.
Yeah. The whole show's in disarray. He doesn't know what the hell he's talking about half the time. And
let's get into the tape. Eric, since you don't appear to listen to your own show, I'm going to play it for you, and I am going to critique it.
I was going to say, has Eric ever listened back besides when we play it for him?
I don't know. No. Can you imagine? How unprofessional is that? Aren't you curious how you're doing?
I take the word of other people.
Yeah, well. And what do they say?
Oh, a lot of people have said this good job.
I got to tell you something. I drive around in my car all day with Howard 100 and Howard 100 on, and I monitor what's going on, including myself.
Right.
I need to hear what's going on and what the show sounds like to a guy in his car. And I know you. I know you block everyone who says anything negative, but maybe some people are trying to help you. He only gets good reviews because he blocks everyone who's negative.
Right.
As soon as you're negative, you're done with Eric.
But, you know, if Eric really was serious about broadcasting, he'd listen.
You have to listen. Listen, I've been going on Letterman show for years. Whenever I appear somewhere, I watch it at least once to see how my performance was.
How do you think you get better?
It's awfully arrogant, Eric, to think that you're going to be a star and a superstar talent without even... You're so bored you're not listening to yourself. All right, I'm going to play this for Eric because this is the opening of the show. I know I played some of these yesterday, but Eric was quite perturbed with me because I played these without him being here.
Oh, really?
Which is ridiculous. But all right, I'll do it here for him now. Here's Eric's opening to the show.
Okay, it's Jeff and Albert Who here. Welcome to the JFSC. Wrong.
By the way, if I may point out, the woman typing over Eric.
Do you hear this, Eric?
And also, I couldn't even make out the first five words Eric said.
I don't know what he's saying.
He said...
But he's trying to work out the name of the show, is what I can, from what I can understand. And he goes, no, that's wrong. And he starts again.
I don't want to start off the show.
Well, if you're doing the impression of Eric, just put your hands over your mouth, Fred.
Yeah, we can hear you too.
By the way, I'm not adding any sound effect to Eric's tape. I assure you, this typing is the real deal.
On the old show, the JFSCTV.com AGT wrap-up show.
That is not me.
Your host, Eric, the actor, which is me, and we're going to recap. The America's Got Talent, it's been on since, what I think, May 14th. I want to address something that happened Monday.
It's so hard to hear you, that's number one. Then, the show continues on, and this woman that he works with, I guess it's the woman, is fumbling around with her papers, and I can't hear a word Eric's saying.
At Parminder
Gift. Her I hear fine.
Oh, yeah, she's loud and overmodulated.
Yeah.
At Parminder Gill. Eric, is it possible you'll stop grunting if you sing a country song?
I don't do that.
That's the host.
I talked to plenty of people on the phone off air or this current show, and not one of them.
That's not me.
It's a combination of it's early in the morning, I just woke up.
Eric, if I did the show, and it
does
sounded,
Eric really want to be on the show? It almost like he is in another room.
Yeah,
out the door.
What if the show sounded like this? Hey, Robin, how you doing today? And I tell you, last night I was watching television. I had a great time.
I'm sure we'd be very successful.
You know, Rob, I'm pretty good. And I got to tell you, I love doing the show, and I love meeting people. On top of that, I mean, you're hard to understand anyway, because you do have that...
No, I fucking don't.
No, you have a voice that is difficult to understand sometimes.
Eric, you're going to tell us you can hear you perfectly.
Now, what do you hear?
Fred, kiss my ass.
Eric, what do you hear when you hear me play back these tapes? Do you think it sounds good? I'll play you another one. Here you. I'm not putting any sound effects on this. Here's Eric talking about, he's recapping his favorite foods. And again, with this paper noise.
At Damon Ike, aside from soda and candy.
Notice there's no noise when she's talking.
Yeah, she's bellowing.
What are some of your favorite foods? Is there anything you aren't allowed to have for your health reasons?
Here we go.
I'll answer one question.
First of all, not only is he far away from the microphone or something, but then she makes it even harder with this. Listen.
No, it's really notice. Nothing
else. Put on some headphones.
On my list of what I can and cannot eat. And,
Eric, do you hear this? Am I making any of this up?
No, you're not, but I don't have a fucking thing to put a fucking pair of headphones into.
Well, this is ridiculous.
Well, then you can't do a broadcast.
And who is this girl? Is she trying to sabotage you?
No.
Who is she? She sits in the room with you?
Yes.
Is she hot?
Yes.
Oh. Well, maybe you don't care then, I guess.
Maybe he doesn't care to be heard. Right. He's got a pretty girl with him.
Is she a professional broadcaster? I mean, who is she? Who is she?
I don't think her and the person that are doing the whole site.
By the way, you say you don't talk like that. Your answer is
because I'm trying to fucking think of the right way to put it, jackass.
No, you talk like.
Because
I'm just saying, Eric, you're hard enough to understand. You've got to be right on that microphone. They can't be fumbling papers, and she's got to quiet down. And instead of calling me a jackass, get a hold of her and whoever's producing that show.
Yeah, you're not angry at them. Yeah,
no, he's angry at me.
Let me explain.
The
pauses in my speech are me trying to think of the right fucking thing to say.
Well, I don't care what the reason is. You're hard to understand when you do that. That's all I'm saying. So I'm willing to put up with that.
I don't want to say the wrong fucking thing and then get stuck with it.
But you understand it makes you sound like this.
Well, as long as we can't hear you, you're not stuck with anything.
Well, yeah, that's true. You're safe. We didn't hear a fucking thing.
So just say whatever.
I'm an Eric the Actor fan. I want to hear what you have to say. I can't hear it. Radio is whether you can hear something or not.
Well, if you would shut up long enough for me to say, maybe you would hear.
All right, tell me tell me an explanation.
I was trying to say the two of them, the person that's the technical person of the JFSCTV.com and her, they're trying to stay behind the scenes. They don't want to be on cam or anything like that.
What's that got to do with anything?
They're doing a horrible job.
I mean, what's that got to do with the fact that does the technical guy wear headphones when you're talking?
Actually, yes, he's the only one that does.
And he doesn't hear this. If
he
was
says
me,
the girl wants to be in the background, but she's the only thing you can hear.
Their actions do not speak of what you say. It's just the way it is. This is what I'm hearing. Here's what I hear. What do you hear, Fred?
It's the Eric the Midget Show.
All right. That's what we hear.
That's it. That's everything you get.
And I know you think I'm being harsh, but I'm the only one being honest with you. Why bother doing a show that we can't hear? Okay? Hello?
I'm here.
Look, if the name of the show was Eric's Paper Crumpling and Typing Sound Show, I would say you got a hit. Because that's what I heard. I heard papers crumbling, typing.
And everybody but Eric. You hear somebody talking very well and loudly.
Right.
And then you hear some guy who sounds like he's outside the studio.
And you know what I've learned in radio, Eric? People will not put up with... You know, they'll try a show for 30 seconds. If it doesn't sound right, they're gone. I'm a hit on radio. I know radio. I don't know much, but I know radio. I can help you with that.
Right.
I'm not saying it to be mean. I'm trying to get you some listeners here. I'm the only one, I think, who even advertises this show. I mean, who else is talking about it? Nobody.
You couldn't talk about it if you were going to talk about content, because you couldn't hear what Eric said.
I mean, who is the engineer, Robin? Lou Ferrigno?
Eric, you're on the air.
You sound great.
You're so damn good. You're dead, John. Keep it up. You're doing great.
Thank you, Lou.
Do you know I'm playing the Incredible Hulk?
Thank you.
All right, Eric. Well, I hope this was of use to you. I don't know. I'm trying to be constructive.
Do you think you'll go back and make some changes?
I'm actually considering possibly putting this show on hiatus till the technical issues get worked out.
I can see why. He's frustrated. Well, let's hope you get it worked out and you don't have to go on hiatus. All your fans are waiting for the next show. I know I am.
Right.
All right, Eric. Well, best of luck getting that all straightened out. I know how frustrating it can be.
One other thing before you let me go. I'm going to try to enter a contest of one of your...
Well, thank you for that, Eric.
I'm under fire. Eric, go ahead. What did you want to say? Hold it.
Incoming,
Robert. Incoming. Eric, what were you saying?
Stop it, Jack.
Robin, duck. I mean, I hear a duck. Oh, it's Eric.
Hey, I'm going to interrupt.
It is an illusion.
Started yesterday.
What contest are you starting?
No, I didn't start it. I'm entering one that started yesterday.
Yeah, what is that?
The ghost.
Hold on, Eric. There's a duck sound. Stop it, duck. Wait, fuck you, duck.
Get a gun and shoot it.
Wait, hold on, Robin. I'll get the gun. Eric, keep talking. Hold it. What did you say, Eric? Something about a contest? All right, I got him.
Duck time.
All right, I'll turn off my gun. Yes, did you say what you had to say?
The Live with Kelly Coast to Coast co-host search.
Oh, that's a good one.
What is it?
The Live with Kelly co-host search. So Eric, the actor, could be a co-host on Live with Kelly?
That. I would do anything to see that.
So do we vote for you?
Well, first step.
By the way, their votes are horseshit because somebody we voted for to be her co-host, they still didn't let him on.
Really?
Remember the last time they had some sort of vote and we put somebody through? Like, we got him a million votes and they still didn't put him through. I think it was Booker.
Oh, yeah.
If we get Eric all the votes, I bet you they won't let him co-host. They won't.
They don't want this great broadcaster?
They don't want, maybe they don't like handicapped people over at that show. Maybe they don't want America to see handicapped people.
They don't want a show that sounds like the one that was played last week?
Well, I think the engineering would be better on that, Robin.
You think Gelman could help
get
Eric on mic?
Do you think Kelly would just be going like this while Eric's talking? Eric, so what do we do to help you? And please don't mind my Geiger counter going off during the show. It's just that you have to test for radiation. Yeah, go ahead.
The first step is I got to send in a video to the website of me trying, I guess, trying to pitch being in the contest.
What?
Wait, there's a snake.
What?
Robin, there's a snake in this.
Where are we?
Well, my engineer won't get rid of it. Hold it, I'll kill it. There we go. Eric, please.
All right. Now,
don't let us interrupt
you.
Yes, you were saying?
I was saying that I have to submit the video by the 29th month.
Wait a minute, somebody's tearing bandages. Somebody must have been hurt.
I accidentally shot myself when I was trying to kill the snake, Robin. But please, Eric, go ahead.
I'll say it a third time.
Please.
I have to submit a video to their website by the 29th.
All right, we'll do it, because we'll all vote for you.
You know, once they see the video, Eric...
Oh, I'm sure it's going to be a great video. Would you send me a copy of the video just so I can see how you're doing?
Where are you taping this video?
I think in the same JFSC studios.
On my laptop, probably.
Yeah. What do you have an agenda for the video you're sending, Kelly?
No, not really.
That's good.
You're just going to do what? What are you planning to say?
I'm going to... Hey, hello, Kelly. Yeah, here's what's in the news. This is what, you know, you should be like Regis. If you're going to get that job, you got to go. Last night, I went out to the 7-Eleven.
It would really be nice if you would let me answer Robin's questions.
Sorry, go ahead. And don't blame the horses that are coming through the studio.
That's right. The Belmont is running through the studio.
Yeah, the Belmont Stakes.
What I was going to do is...
Oh, I got to get out of here.
You are such immature assholes.
You think?
I agree with that.
Yep.
So what is What are you planning to say?
I was going to say that I've been a part of the Howard Stern Show for almost 10 years, and that I've been on TV shows, and just going to give my credits.
Well, I could argue with that approach.
That sounds horrible.
It sounds boring. Yeah. You know, Eric, again, I'm going to give you some free advice. You'd be smart to take it. Notice, like, when Regis was on with Kelly... He would talk about what he did that day. Like, you should get real down with it. Like, you know, hey, I had a great night last night, or I had a miserable night last night, or, you know, don't talk about what you've done. Talk about, you know, what you're doing now and, you know, what you read in the newspaper. Like, Regis would hold up the newspaper and go, can you believe this? The Houston Rockets won! Or something like that.
All right.
Yeah, you got to act like the hosts. Host something.
And then threaten at the end. Just go, I'm a handicapped little person, and if you don't pick me, you're racist. What is it when you don't like little handicapped people? Is that racism?
Well, it's...
What is that?
What is it called?
I mean, there's not even a thing... There's not even a name for that. Yeah. A littlest, I believe, right? If a racist is race, a littlest would be...
Well, a handicappist.
A handicappist littlest. A sizeist. A sizism. You're practicing a sizism.
Got it, Eric?
Yeah.
What are the odds of him getting selected?
None.
Yeah, even if we all vote for him, but I'm going to vote for him. Well, I got to tell you, though, Eric, on one level, I think he got a shot. Because your chipper personality is perfect for a morning show. You know how upbeat you are.
What, I mean, pretend you're on the show.
All right, I'll be Kathy Lee. Eric, you'll be... Oh, right. Kelly Lee. Kelly. Kelly. There's Kathy Lee and Kelly. Yeah.
Her husband presided over your wedding. You can't even remember her name.
I do remember her name. I thought of Kathy Lee. Sorry. All right, you ready? I'm Kelly.
Yes.
And you're...
The co-host.
Hi, everyone. Hello. Welcome to the morning show with Kelly Ripa. And we're very excited today because we're welcoming someone new into our family. new on the show, and by the way, all of you voted, so this is your choice. And I just want to say that Gelman personally picked him. And here he is, Eric the Actor. Maybe you've heard of him from the Howard Stern Show. But he won overwhelmingly. Everyone voted for him. Welcome, Eric.
Thank you, and good morning. Good morning, everybody.
So, Eric, tell us about you a little bit. A lot of people who don't know you. What's going on with you? And please don't touch me, by the way. All right, go ahead.
I've been almost 10 years now, a regular caller into the Howard Stern Show, and I've had...
So you call Howard every morning?
Just about every morning.
Wow. Okay.
I've also had 3 acting parts on 3 different primetime shows. The first one was American Dreams, then Friends, and Plain Sight.
Oh, Plain Sight. Isn't that with Mary McCormick?
Yes, it is.
I don't remember seeing you. What did you play? The doorstop?
I was in the second episode of the first season.
Oh, wow.
I played a landlord.
Okay.
I'm changing the channel. I'm sorry.
Yeah, I thought Eric was going to take over, but he wants to talk about his credentials.
Right, he just wants. And you know, Eric, when you show up, the first thing you say is not that, you know, you've been a caller on the Stern Show for 10 years. You got to explain.
I don't know. You know what, Robin? You don't know everything. Eric's got a plan. Well, Eric, it's great having you here. We're going to bring out the North Shore Animal League now. They're bringing out a 40-pound cat to eat you. He's going to eat you on set. Any funny anecdotes from the set of Plain Sight? Must have been great being on the show.
It was a lot of fun.
Yeah.
What an anecdote.
Did anything fun happen?
Do you know
what
an anecdote is?
Yes, I know what an anecdote is.
Yeah. Oh, he thought I said anecdote.
If you get bit by a snake, you get the anecdote to kill you.
No, Eric, hey, it's so great having you here. You know, I didn't realize what an actor you were. What happened on the set of In Plain Sight that you might tell us about?
Well, just got to meet up the cast and the crew and do my part.
Wow.
Nothing funny happened.
I could see why Gelman picked you out of all the people we could have chosen.
Nothing happened while you were on the set?
I don't mean to tease you, Eric, but I heard you were afraid of werewolves when you were working.
Well, didn't encounter any.
Eric.
Hey, come on, Robin.
Oh, my God.
You don't think this is fascinating?
This is awful.
You don't think Kelly and Eric make a good team?
Eric's not giving anything.
Are you saying if anything ever happened to me, Robin, you wouldn't work with Eric?
No. This would be a nightmare.
Right. You know why she says that? You were waiting for something funny or some funny anecdote. And
you should say, like, you know what, Kelly? Just before I went, one of my friends convinced me that werewolves actually existed, and I thought I might get eaten by one when I went to the set, so I made sure to put a rider in my contract that it had to be werewolf-free.
Look, Elephant Boy's laughing at me. Robin, maybe you should co-host with Kelly. You were pretty good. All right, well, Eric, I wish you luck with all your new endeavors. Please let us know when we can start voting for you, all right?
That'll be never. They'll just totally reject this tape. You better show us that tape before you send it.
Yep, send me the tape so I can critique it and maybe improve it a little, all right?
Okay.
All right. You know, I've taken a special interest in your career, as you know. I mean, I'm responsible for getting you on a lot of shows, and, I feel sort of a sense of responsibility that maybe I could help you with this, this co-hosting thing. In fact, maybe even get that girl that you work with to play Kelly and have some bouncing back and forth between the two of you. That would be my first advice. Rather than make the audition tape yourself, try to get a partner with you.
And then, just to clarify, you guys are on air next week, right?
Yes.
Okay.
Why is that?
Well, so if I send you the tape...
Oh, right. Okay. All right, Eric, I've spent way too much time with you. Best of luck. And please have your engineer listen to the show a little closer. Thank you.
Right.
All right. Just trying to help. All right,
just
Eric.
Remember, poor JD is out there listening.
Right. He's forced to listen. JD's probably the only one who's forced to listen to the entire hour. All right. And with any luck, Eric, if you listen to me, you'll be my heir apparent. You know what that means?
Yes.
What does that mean?
It means the person that follows you.
Uh-huh.
You're designating him.
I'm grooming you. Thank you.
Okay.
Bye for now.
Bye for now.
Right. Eric the actor, everyone.
Eric, there he goes.
Annoying motherfucker.
Robin, by the way, you were very helpful with Eric in trying to mold him.
I just see that audience going down to zero. Well, he starts, I got to meet the stars of the show. And maybe that woman's crumpling papers for a reason. Eric has nothing to say.
All right, we have to take a break. We'll be back right after these words. Hey, before I get into anything, I was listening to Eric the Actor's new AGT wrap-up show.
Oh, that's right. It comes on Wednesdays after the show.
Yeah. If you can find my show, America's Got Talent. It seems to me, I think it's on tonight.
When is it on? I'm
assuming tonight and tomorrow night, but one never do know with that show. It's wild to me how people go, when is it on exactly? Doesn't seem to be clear. And I was going over the summer schedule, the rest of the summer schedule, when we go to live shows. And sometimes it's on Tuesday. Sometimes it's Monday, Tuesday. Sometimes Tuesday, Wednesday. And then sometimes Tuesday, Thursday.
What?
Yeah. I've never seen a show handle that. Usually you have a time slot.
Tuesday, Thursday.
Yeah. Well, they moved it to Tuesday, Wednesday for me. That was the original plan.
Yeah, but you pick a time and a day.
And stick with it. Run with it. But it's okay. But, you know, and I just kind of like go, whatever, whenever it airs, it'll be fine. Show's doing well. What do I care?
But every week you have to check.
It's that good a show. Like, you literally have to just...
You have to go hunt it down.
Yeah, it's worth it. Anyway, Eric the Actor has his America's Got Talent wrap-up show. And they've worked out the technical glitches. You can now hear him.
Okay.
But it hasn't improved the quality of the show any.
Can hear you in the room.
Good evening, room. Can everybody hear me?
It's a good way to open a show.
Good evening, room.
Can everybody hear me? Well,
I've never heard of people referred to as a room before. Good evening, room.
There's a big silence. You don't know what's going on.
Welcome to the JFSATV.com AGT. He wrap-up show.
Well, they have whittled
show
down
over.
That name.
You think? I thought it was kind of low. JFSC, JFSC AGT.
I'm your host, Eric the Ack-Tor.
Eric the Ack-Tor.
Well, it was JFS.
Yeah. Well, he doesn't realize he has a funny delivery.
See,
his breathing is a little strange, but he's a handicapped guy.
This week's show is brought to you by the Viper Room.
Oh, we have a sponsor.
On Tuesday the 26th, go to the Viper Room and check out their karaoke pole dance in competition.
Wow.
And called pole stock.
That's pretty. Karaoke pole dancing competition.
Called.
It will be
what?
Called pole stock.
What does that mean? Are the people on the pole doing the karaoke?
I don't know. What do I know what goes on at the Viper Room? Eric seems to be tied in with the Viper Room.
Good for him.
Yeah.
We'll say bye.
Big pause.
Sam Tripoli, or Tripoli, and porn star Shayla Stiles.
Hmm. Anyway, it's off to a rousing start, and... You want to hear?
What can you say? What can you say?
And then people just call in and or write in, I guess, on his chat room, and they ask him ball busting questions. Like, here's somebody throwing a math question at him, and Eric gets angry.
At Brock Carter 69, ETA. If there are 21 contestants on AGT and 13 suck, How many make it through Las Vegas?
Oh, good grief. Gee, I wonder why they're asking this question. I'm not answering it.
So he won't answer any math questions.
Well, I just realized that Eric the actor is ETA, so now he's ETA.
This is ETA on the JFSCAGT wrap-up. Oh,
there's a lot going on there. So then finally he just starts yelling at everyone for asking math questions.
Despite what some people think, I don't get paid to call into the show. I don't get paid for... You know, having these...
We don't pay him for all those great calls?
Being bad at math.
Yeah.
Miles Porcus. Eric, if AGT is 1 hour long and a marathon shows 4 episodes, how many minutes of AGT were aired?
Enough with the damn math questions, you dumb fucking idiots.
There's some sort of audio problem this week where you notice it cuts out every minute.
Misses some of his words.
Yeah, but makes it funnier.
Kirby Orton, are you voting this fall? And who will you be supporting in the 2012 election?
Yeah, I'll be voting in November and I'll be supporting Obama.
Who?
I think he said Obama.
No, I think he said a llama. I'm supporting a llama.
I'm supporting a llama. They're very furry.
Then people just, all they do during his whole show is try to piss him off with questions, and the girl reads them, you know. Evidently, Eric whistled 1 week on his show. And the whistling, because he's on video, they said his face contorted and looked strange when he whistled, and now he doesn't want to whistle anymore.
I think everyone wants to hear you whistle again. It was very popular.
Yeah.
Maybe we could arrange something that you just do something different.
Well, the other thing besides the fact is it kind of created an issue, the other thing that kind of annoyed me is it didn't even get one bit of attention from Howard. That's one of the main reasons why I did that last week. Was to get Howard's attention.
He won't whistle now.
How did we miss that? Is he a good whistler?
Yeah, the best part is when Eric is now angry with Live with Kelly Ripa.
Why?
Because he's entered the contest to become her co-host for the week. And he's dead serious about it. And now he's thinking of withdrawing because he found out that Kelly doesn't fly in her guest hosts. So what's so great about it is, A, Eric's never going to get chosen. To be the guest host.
This is great, though, because now he can rail and rant.
Yeah. Hey, Eric, I would say, you know what? Why don't you send in a tape to Kelly Ripa, and if you get chosen, then worry about the airfare,
Well, I kind of think with the economic bad timing that we are having right now, that having a contest where you don't pay for the...
Yeah, but I'm saying you're not going to win anyway. You're never going to be the co-host.
It'd be such a fluke.
Yeah, if the fluke happens, we'll figure out how to pay for it.
You don't know if they would choose me or not.
That's what I'm saying.
So let's see if you get chosen.
I'm telling you, they'll never choose you. First of all, can you imagine, like, Eric will get chosen, which would be, like, the greatest thing ever, and he'd be like, I can't get an oxygen tank that quickly, and I can't, you know, like, he would actually probably end up blowing it anyway, which would be so great. Here's Eric mad at Live with Kelly on his radio show.
Eric, are you going to turn in a video to Kelly's show?
Oh, the live... yeah, I've considered that. The only thing is, there's one major thing with it. The people that... They pick
what is that noise?
To do travel cost. They have to buy their own round trip ticket, which I find a little annoying because a lot of these people that are probably going to be entering this contest are people that are out of work and don't have the money to buy round trip tickets. So why make them have to pay for their way?
Yeah, they can afford it. It sure makes a ton of dough.
If they're sitting at home watching live and entering this contest, surely they can afford it.
If they have that much free time. They all must be billionaires, because most people go out and work. Well, Eric, I would enter anyway and see what happens. I'll bet you don't get picked.
Do you have to send in a picture?
And if I do, what will you do?
We'll fly you in.
Yeah, I'll fly you in. I mean, you know, not on a private jet. Disclaimer, 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 but I'll find some money to get you a flight. But you're not going to win. And not only aren't you going to win, you're going to make it a pain in the ass anyway. Then you're going to go, well, you're flying me in, but who's going to put me up? And who's going to, you know?
What day?
What day? And I have to order an oxygen tent.
I have to have two tickets.
Not a tent, you moron.
How do I know?
He wants the tent to play.
Yeah. We need a tent for the plane.
All I need is an oxygen generator, not an oxygen
tent. That's like my problem. Oxygen generator. What are you breathing right now? Oxygen, right?
Yes.
Yeah. What are you worried about? And you know what? You got so much free time. Drive to New York. Imagine if he did
Wouldn't
get picked.
Wouldn't that be fun? Imagine a road trip.
Imagine he got picked by Kelly Ripa to be her co-host.
And then he couldn't get here.
Yeah, and he'd just be like, well, I can't get there. It's like, what else do you have to do but get there? Walk. Have that guy wheel you. It's just crazy, his thought process. What is this? Eric the Actor explains Madonna and Lady Gaga.
Oh, yes, they're feuding. He knows what's at the bottom of this?
Yeah, let's hear that. What?
I just wanted because it's only a minute and then a minute and 11 seconds, but it feels like an hour listening to it.
Yeah, can you imagine? Like, just hearing his Kelly Ripa thing, it's only like 15 seconds and it felt like an hour.
Yes.
All right, let's see if we can sit through this. This is Eric explaining the Madonna-Lady Gaga feud.
Did you see Lady Gaga got hit in New Zealand? By one of her dancers?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I saw that. And I also seen that she's...
Where does he see that, by the way?
Oh, on the internet.
Are you on the internet all day surfing?
No, I watch two shows that have... that are big fans of yours. Extra and Access Hollywood.
Okay.
And a little bit of a war of words with Madonna.
Oh, what are they saying, Eric?
Well, it's because of the fact that Madonna used, because, was it this song?
Oh, boy.
One of Madonna's songs, people thought the song,
oh, my God.
Born This Way sounded a little bit like it. So what Madonna did...
Express yourself.
Yeah, express yourself. What Madonna did was she turned the tables.
You can't express yourself? No.
That's how I me.
During one of her concerts and started performing Express Yourself and added Born This Way in with it. So now I guess Lady Gaga took offense to that and there's a whole... war of words between the two of them.
I didn't hear
beautiful
you.
Show, Eric. I mean, wow.
You look wiped out, Howard.
Oh, Robin, I'm back in my chair snoozing. I'm wiped out.
Oh my goodness.
The clip in white is I edited it together a whole bunch of times. Well, not a whole bunch, but a few times. Where Eric was annoyed with the question.
What does he do? He goes berserk?
He doesn't go berserk, but he's like, fuck you.
At Elwood Lugnut, Eric, have you ever considered doing your old circus act on AGT?
I don't have any old circus acts, you stupid ass.
At Real Disaster Us, Eric, people accuse you of grunting when you're clearing your throat. Can you demonstrate the difference and put this issue to bed?
I don't want to demonstrate the difference.
At Elwood Lugnut.
That seems like a pretty fun thing to hear, Eric, though. What is it? You're claiming you're clearing your throat and they're saying...
Not grunting.
They say you grunt.
Yes.
Yeah.
Oh, JD, come on.
Oh, Christ.
It's great, right?
Not really, but...
Where else but this show would, like, Eric the actor be up?
There's no other show.
Right.
Definitely not Live with Kelly.
What, you don't think he'll get selected?
He's the last person they would want to see on morning television.
Yeah, why aren't your geeky ass in a video?
Yeah.
Because I'm smart enough to know they wouldn't pick me, dummy.
At what point in this show does Eric talk about AGT? I mean, does he ever get to it?
He does.
The wrap-up.
Because, I mean, it's the most boring part. He says he likes this, you know, he liked the squirrel, and that's about it.
You like the squirrel? The squirrel just went round and round and round. It's not who's going to pay $1 million to see that? By the way, too, a lot of what they cut out, too, that squirrel was fucking schnodding and salivating. It was like animal torture to me. I couldn't take it. I was like,
I didn't think it was a great act, but it was funny to watch.
Yeah, it was good. It was good. It was a one-shot deal. It was fun, but I wasn't putting it through.
And I told the news, the same thing with his Idol show back then. It's more a Q&A with Eric with a little bit of recap of AGT and American Idol.
Yeah, but Eric doesn't direct the conversation.
Well,
he comes on and goes... and then he takes questions.
He sounds exhausted.
ETA, do you stick your head out the window when you ride a car?
Oh,
fuck no. Fucking moron.
At Miles Porcus, what is your favorite game at Chuck E. Cheese?
How many fucking times do I have to tell you morons I don't go to Chuck E. Cheese?
Yeah, morons. Come on.
You fucking idiots. I think they know that. I think they're just trying to get under your skin. You've never been to a Chuck E. Cheese? I could see you going there.
Not since the 90s.
What was your favorite game?
What was your favorite game?
I guess back then, skee ball.
Hey. All right.
Well, that's an answer. Ski ball.
See, Eric, that's how you answer the question.
He played ski ball?
No, yeah. I was the ski ball.
In the 90s when my brother was a kid.
All right, okay, I had enough of Eric's show. All right, Eric, very good.
Love Eric's show.
Right. Yeah.
We're talking about...
You love it. That's your show.
Yeah, I love the playback. We wrap up Eric's show.
Yeah, we do a wrap-up of the Eric show.
Well, I really would like to know what he thought of AGT.
He liked a squirrel.
That's it?
Yeah, but you know it's not $1 million act, right, Eric?
Right. And given the fact that he only aired one show last week, there wasn't all that much to talk about.
I know. I was disappointed. I love the show. I mean, if I wasn't even on the show, I'd want to see it.
But does Eric really take notes and have things to say about AGT?
No, I don't take notes because I kind of think that would distract me from enjoying what I'm watching.
So, in other words, you have no idea what to say about the show after it's over?
Well, I try to remember as much as I can.
All right. Okay, thank you, Eric. And listen, we look forward to your show Wednesday on the JFSC,
I'm looking for a better wrap-up this week. I want to hear some AGT information.
Well, he's got two shows to view on Monday and Tuesday.
And he'll have forgotten both by Wednesday.
No, he says he has a good retention. All right, Eric, thank you very much.
Howard.
Yes.
One question, if you could ask Mark Wahlberg if they're ever going to do a Entourage movie.
Okay, I'll ask him. Gary, write down a note that Eric wants to know from Mark Wahlberg if there'll be an Entourage movie.
Okay.
All right. All right, Eric, it'll be done.
Is he making his video?
Are you gonna make a video for the Kelly Ripa show?
I'll try to make it by tomorrow, so that way it could be you guys on Wednesday, because you said you wanted to review it first.
Yes.
Yes. All right. Thank you. Yeah.
What would you say what would you say the odds are that he gets on the show?
Zero.
Like 1,000,000 to 1, 10,000,000 to 1?
No. There's no odds. It's zero. Zero to zero. Zero chance. I don't even need a chance to look at it.
0.0.
Even with the fact that she's a fan of yours? Oh, you don't think she'd...
No. Pick? There's no way in hell she's putting you on that show. A, you have trouble speaking. I know you don't think so, but you do. Your thoughts are slow, and your speech is slow. Secondly, you know, when do you ever see handicapped people on TV? Barely ever. You know, no, everyone's looking for perfect. Look at her. I mean, everyone's looking for perfect people.
Well, see, I think you'd be the perfect contrast.
Yeah, but she'll look unbelievably beautiful. I mean, she looks beautiful already, but she'll look even more beautiful.
Oh, can I just say one thing to Eric, too? Eric, the handful of times that you do see handicapped people on television, they overcompensate for the handicap with this amazing personality.
Right. They have like an upbeat personality, like they're awesome, like insane. You sit there and you go, oh my god, and I'm so inspired.
Your point is,
I mean, the closest thing I can think of to a host who was handicapped was Bill Cullen, who was on The Price is Right years ago,
and he never moved, couldn't see it.
Yeah, you couldn't tell. You know, but she's got a talk show where they're, you know, there's no way, and you're not real good at talking. I mean, the only, you know, maybe you could get an after school special, but I don't know about this. I think you're out of your league on this.
The only time Eric's a good talker is when he's angry.
Right.
And you can't do a morning show like that.
And Kelly's not going to do angry talk with him. She's going to be like, listen, you fucking little fidget, you know, and then get him all worked up.
Eric, what's your favorite game at Chuck E. Cheese?
I don't think she's going to ask him about his favorite game of Chuck E. Cheese. She's not going to want to offend him.
Right.
You know, but, you know, whenever I see handicapped people on TV, they're very, very upbeat. Like, we had guys in here with no legs and no hands. And
yeah,
like,
remember that tennis player that we had in? He was amazing.
He had no feet or something. And, like, you know, he's just like, you know, I don't care. I can overcome anything. Eric gets on. People hate the handicapped. I've never seen so many people write me hating the handicap after Eric's
after
on the radio.
Eric, oh dear.
And I'm like, poor Eric's handicapped. They go, don't feel bad for him. Fuck him. I mean, people hate Eric. So I don't see how in hell there's a zero chance that you would get on the Kelly Ripa show. Zero. But I can't wait for the tape. And I think you should make the tape with like a co-host, you know, like try to make it as much like the Kelly Ripa show as possible.
Right. You know, I talked to one of your, I guess, say frequent guests a lot on the phone. And I don't have any problem talking to her at a normal rate of speed. And other stuff, every time I've talked to her on the phone, I've never talked to her slowly or anything like that.
All right, hey, well, prove me wrong. I'm telling you, you have zero chance.
He has no clue. Yeah. I think if you think that's your best shot at doing it, get her to do the tape with you.
Right. Do it with your friend. All right. Well, send me the tape. I'll critique it.
Yeah. How's that possible? Tabitha lives in Vegas.
Oh. Wow. Oh,
well, that's too bad.
Yeah. All right. Well, I got to go anyway, okay?
I wonder why he wanted you to see his whistling.
Because he thought it'd be funny, and I'd talk about it on the air and stuff.
What is it about his whistling?
Because he makes weird faces when he whistles. And people were making fun of Eric, and Eric doesn't want to be made fun of. All right, enough of the Eric world. Eric, I got to go. Keep me posted on the Kelly Ripa thing, and let me know about the new AGT wrap-up show. Thank you.
Okay.
All right, later. All right. I mean, how many minutes can I spend with him?
I would like to hear him whistle now. I'm very intrigued.
Yeah, but you got to see him whistle. That's the whole appeal. That's why he doesn't want to do it anymore. After he whistled, everybody was tweeting pictures of him whistling.
Oh, my goodness.
And, you know, it wasn't his best look.
You're looking for a certain level of enthusiasm from me.
Well, you are the show. I mean, you're the prime generator of the whole thing.
I'm the spark.
Yeah.
I really do think I am.
I think you are.
Thank you, Robin. I don't think Howie and Sharon think I am.
No, I think they know you are.
They love it.
I'm like, they're like glad you came.
Maybe. I don't know. How about AGH? America's Got Howard, and we just do our thing. By the way, speaking of AGT, Eric the Actor did another.
Oh, no.
He did another wrap-up show.
Yeah.
And because of you, Robin, he devoted some time to America's Got Talent to actually talking about it.
Well, that's what he's supposed to be doing.
Yeah. He devoted, I think, a minute to it. But because the rest of the time he's just busy with questions.
Yeah.
I'll play it for you tomorrow because we should get to the news.
Yeah, because if he's just answering questions about himself, it's a Eric the Actor wrap-up show.
Yeah, well, okay, here's one little teaser for tomorrow. Here's Eric from his AGT recap show.
So let's see, what's...
And he got rid of his female co-host, I think. She wasn't there.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
So let's see, what's first to talk about with AGT? Monday night, they aired their last city audition, which, of course, was just pretty much compilation of the different cities all put together in one.
Oh.
Wow. That was a highlight?
Well, it's 20 seconds of the highlight, but didn't it feel like an hour went by?
Oh, it's awful.
Yeah.
They showed a max that they hadn't owned yet before.
They hadn't owned yet? I think Eric is insufferable. You know, Bill Maher had Kirk Douglas on.
I saw a little bit of that.
And, you know, I feel like... two different ways about it.
What are you saying?
Yeah, I loved it and I hated it all at the same time.
I mean, I love Kirk Douglas in that he's an old guy who had a stroke, and rather than hide away, he's trying to, you know, live a normal life. And like Jim Brewer said, you know, we take old people and discard them. So I get all that. Like, it's important. But
he writes these books and then he comes out to promote them.
And Bill Maher, I guess, somehow fell for it because it's really difficult to listen to him on TV.
It was almost like Bill was the only one who understood.
And I don't even think Bill knew what he was talking about.
And he
about.
Was trying to repeat what he was saying to the audience.
Bill asked Kirk Douglas at one point why he wrote the book. I have no idea what the answer was.
I wrote this book because now we have a divisive situation all over Europe and all over America, for example.
I mean, it's sad.
Yeah.
And Bill's sitting there being polite, which he's got to be.
Right, he can't interrupt.
But you know TV's just turned the fuck off when this is going on.
Well, actually, it made me watch.
It did? All right, yeah. So it worked.
Yeah.
The
you watched?
Yeah, oh, my God, he's talking to Kirk Douglas. I stayed for every word.
I'm pretty sure I'm going to hide away if this happens to me.
Well, like I said, most people disappear. Like, you haven't seen Gene Hackman. You haven't seen Sean Connery. You know, they want to be remembered as they were.
Right, right. No, not Kirk Douglas. Why'd you write the book, Howard? What? If you see me doing that, let's say I have a stroke, you know, who knows? You know, it could happen. And you see I write a book, and I tell you, Robin, I'm...
going on tour.
Why'd you write the book, Howard?
The Republican... The Democrats.
I want you to give me the big X.
I'll get a wheelbarrow and get you right out of it.
Just take me right out.
Where are the Americans?
You watched the whole interview?
I did. I came in sort of in the middle, so I didn't see the first part, but I was just I said, I got to see how much he can answer.
I love that the audience clapped, too.
And then he was making jokes, and then he'd look at the audience, and they were giving him, you know, like the courtesy laughs.
Right.
And they didn't know what he was joking about.
Sometimes I think J.D. had a stroke.
Because when I look backwards...
Bill Maher asked Kirk Douglas about the blacklist. Remember, he was blacklisted.
Right, yeah.
Actors were being blacklisted and writers were being blacklisted.
During the
communist witch hunt.
Right.
The McCarthy era.
Because when I look backwards, I saw when I did... Spartacus, and you couldn't use a name that would not accepted by the it was
right. Whoa.
Who's worse, Eric the Actor or Kirk Douglas?
I don't know. I'm thinking about that. That's a tough
dead
one.
Heat.
They had some good ones, including Florence Griffin Joyner's daughter. She did a really good job. She...
Oh, boy.
It's a battle of the bands.
Yeah.
You couldn't... Dalton Trumbo couldn't work before you.
No. And House Thomas was the chairman of the committee, and he sent in all the blacklisted voices.
I miss Dick Clark.
Well, this is what I'm thinking, that Kirk is back because Dick Clark had stolen his thunder for
right.
a while.
Right. Yeah, that's true.
You couldn't tell people in the 40s and 50s when you were a movie star that you were a Jew. It was like being gay then.
Do I have a choice?
What did he say?
He actually said, I got this time. When I first heard it, I didn't know what he said.
Apple
he said,
shush.
Do I have a choice?
A source?
Being gay or being Jewish?
Oh, a choice.
Yeah, Bill doesn't even know what the
yeah,
fuck he
Yeah, Bill said. Is interpreting.
Ay, ay, ay.
And then at the end of the interview, did you see that Bill said, we'll have lunch again, right? So he goes out and enjoys this kind of conversation when he doesn't have to work.
What do you want for breakfast, Kirk? Salami?
Talk my day.
Talk my day. Holy mackerel. But on the one hand, I do feel good that he's out there. You know, he's like, hey, fuck you if I have a stroke.
Well, the thing is, I mean, it's one thing, you know, to be, you know, still involved with your family, your friends, whoever. It's another thing to go on broadcast television.
And we're back with the Jack and Rod radio show. And let's hear it for Jeff and Shirley Lawrence. They wrote a book called Hollywood Be Thy Name. Is that correct?
That's it.
Okay, the premise of the book is to let people know what actually goes on in Hollywood. If you want to be an actor, these are things you should know and what we wish we did know when we went there.
This is Rod Stiffington. I just want to tell you, we have a special celebrity guest in the studio today.
Okay, that sounds great.
Go ahead, celebrity guest.
Doug Douglas.
Thank you. You recognize the voice?
Doug Douglas.
No, I'm afraid we're stuck there.
It's Kirk Douglas.
Oh, yeah. Well, I thought that.
Oh, my goodness.
Thank
you.
You know, I thought that, but I thought, no, you're not going to have that star on your show.
I'm delighted. Kirk Douglas, I met you when we were filming a movie. Oh, this was years ago.
Spartacus.
Your makeup man. Yes, I worked with you on Spartacus, and there was one other
I remember show. You.
Well, I don't know if you did
it. Dude, it's beautiful.
Well, we've always admired you.
Oh, absolutely.
I see the biography a lot.
Dick Douglas, I love your book.
Well, thank you.
My son. Do you like my son?
Oh, absolutely.
Oh, okay.
Although I've never worked with Michael.
Crackhead
he's
Bob.
He's a marvelous actor. He certainly married a beautiful woman. I certainly hope that the Douglas family keeps on going through in the movies and times to come because you're the very best.
Duck my duck.
Yes, you and your son.
Okay.
We saw you recently on something, and you're still just absolutely marvelous.
Okay, but I want my duck.
Your son.
My penis.
Martinez.
Yeah, yes, yes.
We admire you greatly.
Beautiful.
You know what? He's one of the greatest actors of all time.
Thank you. I like your tits.
You like what?
I like the tootsie.
That you like the poetry.
Oh, yeah.
That shows your feminine side, Kirk, see?
You're tootsie.
He likes the poetry. Right?
Yeah.
It has a lot to do with the business.
It's painful to listen even to this.
I know.
Oh, man. Well, anyway. You understand. I can't believe you watched that whole interview.
Well, I told you I missed the first part. I'm glad you played a little bit of it for me so that I could know what happened before I tuned in.
Anyway, so Eric the actor and Kirk Douglas have a lot in common.
Yeah, I didn't even care why Kirk was there. I didn't even know he had written a book.
Right. You didn't get that out of it.
He will make it past the Vegas rounds unless there was some major screw-ups on her part. And there was, let's see, what else was there? I wasn't completely clear because some...
Wow.
He wasn't clear, so...
Do you think anyone is listening to that whole show of his?
No.
Oh, Eric the actor is on the phone. Yes,
oh,
Eric.
We haven't talked to him this week.
Yeah, I got a lot to get to, though.
Good morning.
Hey. Hey, Eric. What's happening?
Not much. Just going to do a couple things. One, clear the air, because I don't know if you heard or not, but there are...
I'm so bored already, Eric.
No, I don't think we're going to hear it.
You're not doing anything... Like, Gary, you're not doing anything wrong. You're just talking, but
you know what I just thought?
Oh, my God.
Eric, the actor playlist.
Yeah, we got to get him on playlist. Do you have favorite songs? Are you a music guy? Do you like music?
Yes.
Yeah. Oh, we got to do it. Like, could you introduce songs and talk about why you like them?
Yeah, I could probably do that.
Howard, I'm calling today to clear up a few things.
Oh, my God. It's a few things. It's not going to be just one thing.
I need to clear the air.
Oh. He's been calling in every day for, like, the last, I don't know, couple of days, and I haven't gotten to him, and I felt bad. I saw him up there. I love Eric, but someday, you got to be in the, you know, I'm in a kind of in a shitty mood, just anticipating how long my day is going to be.
Right.
Like, today's going to be the day I decide whether or not I'm returning to America's Got Talent, because if I could survive this, I could survive anything. What is it, Gary?
Do you want to know what Eric wants to talk about? Because I
can you just do it fast?
I can give it to you in 10 seconds,
God,
and then Eric, you can go from here. Apparently, because he's been emailing all of us a lot, somebody's been impersonating him on Twitter. Is it Twitter, Eric? Am I correct?
No.
Oh,
what it is...
I wish you knew.
Somebody on Twitter is impersonating two radio DJs and saying that I've been calling into their show bad-mouthing you, Gary.
Oh, I know about this. Okay, stop. I know about this. Apology accepted. Yeah, Eric, it was reported to me that Eric was calling in other radio shows.
Uh-huh.
And Eric wants to make clear today that it is not him.
No. Definitely not.
Right. Okay.
Okay. All right. See you later.
Well, also wanted to say, after this weekend's Vegas trip, I'm going to start a drawing that I will send you in honor of Bianca.
Oh, thank you. Very nice. By the way.
He draws?
Yeah, he draws.
Yeah.
He draws as well as he speaks. Eric was very nice to generously donate. He's not doesn't
he
have a lot of money.
Donate.
In the name of Bianca, the North Shore Animal League. And I got to tell you something. Our fans are spectacular. My wife wanted to call in today. I told her not to, but she was moved to tears over the outpouring of love. Really, really beautiful.
I received a thank you card last
Yeah,
week.
She is sitting.
She
sits
wrote
in my
you
house.
A thank you card.
She wrote to Eric. She wrote to anyone who donated. She wrote a personal note. And I was like, wow, honey, what are you doing? I mean, she spends her entire day. She says, if somebody donates, how could I not thank them?
That's sweet.
She has no idea that in show business you don't give a shit. But she's not that type.
And she wrote really nice notes.
Yeah. Oh, she
like,
said
like, they weren't just like hey, thanks a lot.
Yeah. No.
Yeah. It was not a form.
I said you gotta love this woman. Oh, I love her. She is. She's a saint. She's a saint. I don't deserve her. Believe me. But thank you, Eric, and thank you for doing that. Yeah.
If you go to JD page one in the first column, you know, apparently Eric, I think on his own, once did a country music countdown show.
Oh, no.
And we have clips of it.
Oh, you're kidding. So this will probably turn me off to the idea of him.
Oh, no, well, if I got, do.
Let's put it this way. If I got 10 songs on my show, the way he talks, you'd probably get 5 in.
Right. And are they all country songs?
Yeah, because he's really into country.
Is that
what it's going to be, Eric?
Can you ban country music from your list?
Probably not.
Yeah.
Come on, don't you have a wider
taste?
Loves than that? Taste than that?
Let's hear some of this.
What's that? That was Jules' debut.
Oh my God, where is he? What happened?
He's talking still.
What happened there, Eric?
Well, I guess the next song's starting, but a lot of DJs do that. They talk through the intro.
Yeah, but you can't hear you.
They lower the music so you can hear them talking, and then they push it up, Eric.
Yeah, yeah. That, you got to be heard when you're doing the talk up.
Right.
Right. I got to hear that again. That's a good one.
That was Jules' debut.
Eric,
that's
come on.
That's the best.
This is me you're talking to.
Look at his favorites. Where is he?
Okay, now we have every other.
Oh my God!
It's toys and clothes.
It's a duet by Reba McEntire.
Is everybody in okay?
This is a new technique. You talk when the the vocal starts.
Yeah. Okay, here's a song by Reba McEntire. Tire.
The song's going. It's a disaster, Eric. We got to get you.
Reeve
is
already singing.
Yeah, get Eric on playlist. All right, Eric. Thank you.
No problem.
Later, Eric the Ack-Tor. Everybody. You know, I actually like the name Eric the Ack-Tor better than Eric the Midget.
Yeah,
I actually do.
It means less.
Yeah. It's like, it's insane.
Eric the Ack-Tor.
Right. All right, thanks, Eric.
Talk to you later.
Later. Bye for now.
Red Rod.
So, yeah, getting back to Richie Wilson's wedding.
Yes.
It's funny to see who wasn't invited.
Who was not
invited?
Well,
it's 7:05. I should take a break. I mean, 5 after the hour. Let me continue that when we get back, okay? Eric the Ack-Tor, you're on the air. I haven't heard from you in a while.
First, before I get too loud, call it for the thing that you were saying about Linda McMahon. You said that she created 600 jobs. Give me a break. Not all 600 jobs have to be shaved in bikinis and all that.
All right. Eric, we know. Eric, these are just like sort of things to make people laugh.
I'm not making sense.
Yeah, don't try to make sense out of anything we say. You know, Eric has like no sense of humor, by the way.
No.
We know that all the jobs aren't about guys in bikinis getting shaved. Believe me. And the audience knows.
Those guys aren't even in Connecticut.
Yeah, my job is to make people smile.
And then the other thing.
I have to explain the show to him.
Yesterday, Gary made a severe mistake. For somebody that supposedly has a 121 IQ, he's an idiot.
Well, okay, go ahead. Give me an example.
Give us an example.
Debbie's Twitter account does not have more followers than mine.
It wasn't the Twitter account.
It was, was your webpage, I guess?
It was the JFS.
JFSC.
Okay, then technically he's right because I don't have a
website. Then apologize to me. Apologize.
I don't. Well, you're only right by default because I don't
You're wrong because you don't know the difference between Twitter and
Twitter. No, because Eric's saying he's not on JFSC anymore. So it's not really his page. He does have you on a technicality.
I mean, who knows what he does? Like, he didn't call me and say, I'm no longer on JFSC. We didn't know that.
Who even cared?
I said that months ago that Johnny and I fired the guy.
All right. Hey, Eric. Thanks for the call.
I'm complaining, midget. Can you finally fucking play my TNA video?
What?
Oh, please, Eric. It's so bad.
I'm going to be fired for you not getting the attention to the video.
You hear what's going on? Eric got this gig where he calls into some show about TNA wrestling.
Right.
And obviously they hired Eric
to get exposure.
Yeah, because see, they know we talk about it here on the air. So yeah. I've purposely been ignoring Eric because I've heard these TNA clips and they're just insufferably awful. Dull. And like, there's nothing even to make fun of. It's so bad. It's so bad that it's like bad to even listen to them. And so it'll
hurt us.
I've chosen not to expose my audience to Eric's unbelievable appearances on TNA. And then he has the nerve to call me and goes, I'm going to get fired if you don't play the clips.
Then maybe.
You should be fired.
Then maybe they won't expose North Shore to any money if I win.
Oh, please. Oh, if you start that again, Eric, that's just, that
this
makes you
blackmail.
Look, that makes you look like an idiot. First of all, how much money have you donated to North Shore Animal League? $5?
No.
How much?
50 once a lot.
All right, 50.
That
so
was
you,
one
you take it away their $50. As much as I appreciate that, and I told you, my wife even wrote you a letter. But, you know, I don't threaten little innocent animals that are going to be, you know, dead. But by saying, if you don't play my stupid TNA thing, I'm not donating to North Shore Animal League. Don't donate.
He's strong-arming you.
What am I going to do?
The puppies.
This Christmas, I'll donate an extra 50 to make up for your 50 you're not going to donate.
Well, I'm quite sure if I won that TNA was going to donate a whole lot more than
no,
$50.
Whatever.
Well, win on your own.
I'm not going to be blackmailed into pay. Is there one clip I can play?
I've been pushing for this one. I think it's funny when the wrestler yells at Eric.
All right, I'll play that.
JD1 in white.
All right, Eric, here's one of your clips. I can't wait to see your big donation to North Shore Animal League. Here we go.
It's going to be out of their money.
By the way, this show is so bad. It's like a show on the internet about TNA wrestling. And Eric was hired to be a part of it. And Eric, they don't even show him on camera because I think it depresses people too much.
Right. And they can't yell at him if they show him.
Yeah, I mean, once you see Eric on camera, no wrestler, I don't even care if he plays the bad guy, is going to yell at Eric. I mean, it's the only reason I'm able to be so tough with Eric is because I'm not looking at him. If I had to look at him right now, I would just melt.
Well, that was the thing. We used to look at him on screen all the time. And right. You couldn't say a bad word.
No, it's heartbreaking.
They actually were looking at me. They just didn't have their cameras set up where it would record me. But
exactly. Exactly.
Right. Nobody can see who they're yelling at.
The audience can't see how, you know, heartbreaking you are. All right, so here's Eric again with that way he speaks, you know, that broken sort of gasping speech pattern. Like when he talks, you have to sit there and suffer
like
through
when
it.
He said that Gary made a severe mistake.
Yeah, yeah, that's all I hear. I hear Fred's impression when I listen to her. He's like,
I missed the sub, and I was just like,
well, you're just playing.
Gary made a veer.
All right, here's Eric the actor.
One match you did get right, Eric, was the street fight between Bobby Roode and the cowboy James Storm. You picked that one correctly.
Yes, I did. But also, Mike Tenay picked Storm to win, too.
But do you remember what you wanted to see at the end of that?
Yeah, and that didn't happen because Roode rushed himself out of the arena.
Well, now, right before we came on the air, what was the term that you used to me about Bobby Roode?
I mean, is anybody still listening to this?
This is awful.
Oh, it's the worst.
I said that he hurried his chicken ass out of the arena.
I thought he said. You might want to, maybe not the right. Yeah, you hurried.
And now everyone's got to now fake, like, uh-oh, Bobby Roode just walked in the room.
Bobby Roode heard what you said.
Bobby Roode heard Eric, and now we're going to pretend that he's really mad at Eric when he's like, oh, my God, thank God I'm not Eric. Bobby Roode's like, oy vey, how can
it's
I yell?
It's okay, Eric, call me whatever you want.
Bobby Roode's in the back room going, you're not going to show what this guy looks like, I hope, on camera when
he has
I'm
to go to a dark place to yell at him.
Poor Bobby Roode. The hardest assignment of his Bobby Roode career.
Chicken ass.
I heard what?
Bobby Roode is here, Eric.
Eric, where are you right now? Sacramento.
That's a surprise. Why don't you ever show your face around me, huh?
Because you wouldn't be yelling at him like this.
No, because he's stuck in a chair and can't get there.
Yeah, you should have just said, because I'm a club fucking footed asshole.
Did you like the match? Did you watch the pay-per-view, Eric?
Did you watch it?
Yes or no? Did you watch the pay-per-view?
Look at this poor guy trying to work a scene with Eric.
Yeah, gotta work into something here.
Bobby Roode left wrestling after this.
It's too much hard work.
You got a job at a bank.
Ooh.
Yes, I did.
Okay, what was your favorite match?
I'd say Watch and Storm beat you.
Storm beat me. Look at me, Eric. Still standing. I'm still here. I heard you say that I got my ass handed to me. Did you say that earlier this week, that I got my ass handed to me?
Watch it. Storm beat you.
And Eric starts talking, and Bobby Roode can't even hear him. Bobby Roode probably goes home. He probably takes a big shot of some whiskey, and he goes, "What the fuck?"
He's on heroin at this point. Just shoot me up.
I'm arguing with a cripple.
My life's not worth living.
The guy's the size of a mushroom. I'm arguing with him. What kind of human being am I?
And terrible at improv.
Right. The improv. All right, Fred. I'll be Bobby Roode. You be Eric. All right.
Hey, Eric. What was your favorite match of the night? Right. What card?
Did you watch the pay per view? You got to ask that five times.
Hey. What? Fuck you, man. Why don't you ever come down to the match?
Is that what you said?
Yes.
Now you're sitting in Sacramento. Hiding. The chicken shit that you are.
Yeah, why don't you come down and fight Bobby Roode in your wheelchair?
Yeah, you got a big mouth in Sacramento.
Yeah. You imagine if Eric wheeled in there and Bobby Roode would be like, oh, I'm so
sorry. Come on, Bobby Roode.
Oh, my God, I'm going to hell. God is going to punish me for this.
Body slamming.
Bobby Roode should pick up that chair and throw Eric out a window.
I would buy that pay-per-view.
You want to be a man, Eric? Man up.
Right.
I'm here every week. You know where you
He's challenging a guy in a wheelchair to a fight.
Why haven't you taken up that challenge, Eric?
And Eric's just quiet, you know. Doesn't say I'm in a wheelchair. Why don't they make you a wrestler? That'd be great, Eric. Like you wheel in your underpants.
Hello?
What?
Well, I have been thinking about not challenging him myself, but saying to him and one other guy I was arguing with on Twitter that works for TNA to take the challenge of taking on two guys that I find.
That's no fun.
Nah.
It was to you.
Why? What if they let you have your... What if? Listen to me. Cut the bullshit. What if your wheelchair could have special weapons? Like literally, like little rockets that fire out and attack.
Like the James Bond car.
Right, yeah.
Like the thing that comes out of the wheel and cuts the tires.
Cut people's legs.
I'll cut you down.
Look for Skyfall.
What?
Look for Skyfall. Open Friday.
Find me? I'm still standing.
I mean, that's ridiculous.
Oh, shut up, JB. No. I heard you're good friends with RVD now. You guys are tweeting each other, huh? You're following RVD? Are you following RVD on Twitter? Great. You know what? Why don't you follow me? Why don't you follow my foot up your ass, you stupid son of a bitch?
Easy.
You better hope I don't ever see you. You understand?
Oh, you better hope you never see
him. Yeah, because you'll be so sorry.
You're going to feel like a real idiot. That poor Eric Roode. I hope they gave him double his salary. He's got to yell at a cripple in a wheelchair who's the size of a grape. You know? He's yelling at a guy whose hands are like plums. It's ridiculous. Eric, the whole premise is completely ridiculous.
So when you took this job, you took it in a, with the idea that you could get them big promotion.
I took it to be able to work with Jeremy, to be able to work in some capacity in that company, and to possibly earn some money for North or Animal Week.
Yeah, but now you're telling us you could get fired if it's not mentioned on our show.
Well, yeah, it's a lot cheaper to pay Eric than to buy a commercial on our show.
Amy, what happened? What would happen? What would you possibly do to him? I would punt you 30 yards out of your chair. Is what I would do.
Wow, that's good.
See, now that's
I'd
something he
that.
Could do with Eric.
Imagine he sees Eric, he takes him, rips him out of the chair, and punts him over.
Right through some goalposts.
Don't ever, ever, ever get in my way, Eric. I'm telling you right now. Stay in Sacramento, and you better hope to God that I never come there, because I'll find you. Stupid son of a bitch.
And this poor guy, like, he needs someone to argue with him?
Yeah, and there's no comeback.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, like, it's just some guy on some weird line.
No, they edited my comebacks out.
Oh, I wonder why.
That exchange was longer, and I hit him with some pretty good comebacks.
No, okay.
Oh, so it was more boring than it is now.
Yeah, so you mean they took out all the excitement and edited you out. You know that if they edited it, Eric must have been awful in the fight.
Yeah.
They'd rather have long pauses than hear him.
No.
Well, you really did it this time, kid.
Who did it, Eric Rude?
Yeah. Eric, I guess.
Eric went too far.
He refers to himself as the it factor.
All right. I've heard enough of the wrestling. I don't care about
it. You don't want to get wrapped up
factor.
In your world.
I'm the ick factor.
What was your comeback?
I called him the shit factor.
Oh.
Got him. They took that out?
Why would they take that out?
I don't know.
Yeah.
But I was also kind of hoping you'd play the exchange between myself and ODB, because if I do win the picks on this pay-per-view, not only does North Shore...
All right. I'm zoning. I don't have the ability to edit you. By the way, the people from Cougar Town, just so you know, have already contacted Ronnie. I don't think anyone's called for Eric. I think they just saw him as too much trouble. Am I correct in that, Eric?
I guess so.
Yeah.
We knew that Ronnie got the job.
Here's Ronnie. Ronnie, when are you going to go out and shoot Cougar Town, since you seem to be getting Eric's acting work?
No, I was just curious if they got in touch with him, because I've been in touch with them, they've been in touch with me.
No, they're not looking for that.
I'm going out there December 16th.
I got to be honest with you, though. I would love to see Eric in Cougar Town.
Yeah, it's much more fun to have Eric on a set.
Yeah, well, they fly me out, put me in this first-class hotel, limo service, the whole deal.
See, you're going to appreciate everything. Right?
Yeah, the problem
it's
gonna
is, be great.
Yeah, you'll probably do just fine. It's funny when Eric's on these shows.
Yeah, I'm going to be out there for 3 days, Eric, shooting.
Okay.
Yeah, December 16th.
Do you know your part yet?
Just come hang out.
Do you know your role?
No, not yet.
All right. You don't care what it is?
No.
Eric would have had that job, except he was being
too
picky.
He wouldn't do anything.
I heard something about like being a fire hydrant maybe or something.
You're going to be a fire hydrant?
Yeah, I don't know.
All right, who cares?
No.
Ask them for 2 liters of Pepsi when you go out
right,
there. All right,
exactly.
All right, thank you, Ronnie. Ronnie, by the way, Ronnie did vote. Thank you, Eric. Appreciate it. Bye-bye.